fans, without you, none of this happens.
Gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs, welcome to the 2017 JUNO Awards nominee press conference.
Please welcome to the stage the president and CEO of CARAS, the JUNO Awards, and MusiCounts, Mr. Allan Reid.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks for braving the weather and joining us here today. And thanks so much for joining us to honor the 2017 JUNO Award nominees here at REBEL. I'd like to thank Inc. Entertainment and Charles Caboof and the entire team for welcoming us in this incredible venue. I've actually been spending quite a bit of time here in the last couple months watching bands like Tory Lanez and Party Next Door, Sam Roberts Band, and Tribe Called Red. And I gotta say, this is a fantastic sounding and looking room, so thanks for having us this morning. Yes. This year, the JUNO Awards are celebrating 46 years of excellence in Canadian music, and what an incredible year it has been for all of our artists, as you will see shortly with the list of nominees. This will be the JUNO Awards' third trip to our nation's capital, and just in time for the country's biggest party. As we celebrate the 150th anniversary of Confederation, the JUNO Awards and the Ottawa Host Committee are hard at work planning this year's JUNO Week, and we think it's going to be one of the best you've ever seen. I'd like to take a moment right now to first off congratulate our special award recipients. First of all, this year's inductee into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame, none other than Sarah McLachlan. Her remarkable career spans almost 30 years, but Sarah is known not only for her passion for music, but also for her philanthropic efforts. We're looking forward to honoring her. Congratulations, Sarah. I'd also like to acknowledge this year's recipient of the Walt Grealis Special Achievement Award. He's someone I personally have a lot of respect for and had the honor of working with back in my days at Universal Music Canada. And I'm sure almost everybody in this room is well aware of who he is. Congratulations, Randy Lennox. I would also like to recognize this year's recipient of the Alan Waters Humanitarian Award presented by Bell Media. Buffy St. Marie. Yes. You know, Buffy exemplifies the essence of humanitarianism through her dedication to protecting Indigenous communities and their intellectual property. And you'll see all three of these extraordinary individuals being honored in Ottawa this year. So congratulations to all of you. CARAS is also celebrating a very special milestone this year, the 20th anniversary of MusiCounts. Now, the evolution of Canada's music education charity over the past 20 years has been more than I think we could ever have imagined. I'm very proud to say that to date, MusiCounts has contributed more than $9 million worth of instruments to kids who need them most, all across this country. Yes. And these funds have impacted over 850 schools and communities, supported over 350 post-secondary music program graduates, and honored 12 extraordinary music teachers through the MusiCounts Teacher of the Year Award. And starting today, MusiCounts are launching a text-to-donate campaign in honor of their 20th anniversary. All you need to do is text the word music to 20222. That's music to 20222 to donate $20. Now, I know you all have phones in your hands, so please try it out. Now, I'm also very proud to make our first Juno broadcast performer announcement of the day. This Edmonton native's breakthrough hit, Lost Boy, which was inspired by a century-old play, was heard around the world. Singer-songwriter Ruth B. will be performing a special tribute to MusiCounts and their 20th anniversary on the Juno stage. Yes, thank you. Tickets are already on sale for the Juno's broadcast at the Canadian Tire Centre on April 2nd. You can visit ticketmaster.ca to get yours now. Trust me, tickets are going fast, but we are going to be releasing some more tickets today, so make sure you pick them up. I also want to mention that we are partnering with Plus One this year, and $1 from every ticket sold will be donated to MusiCounts. Now, there's a considerable amount of work that goes into producing Juno Week and the Juno Awards, and I want to first off take this opportunity to thank the CARAS Board of Directors for their continued support, and also a heartfelt thank to the CARAS staff. I've got an absolutely amazing team who are helping put this on. Guys, thank you for everything you do for CARAS. Thanks also to Deb Goldblatt-Sadowski and our PR team at Rocket Promotions. You guys have become a definite part of the family here at CARAS, and thanks for putting on this event today. A big thanks also to John, Barb, Lindsay, and everyone at Insight Productions for their dedication and partnership to the Juno broadcast each year. These guys are the best in the business, so guys, thanks again. And this will be our 16th year that CTV has been our committed broadcast partner and brought Canada's Music Awards into the homes of millions across this country. I'd like to thank Randy, Corey, Mike, and everyone at Bell Media for their continued support to the Junos and to Canadian music. Yes. I'd also like to recognize Guy Laflamme and members of the Ottawa Host Committee who are here with us today. They got up really early to take the train in. Aaron Benjamin, Patrick Bourbonnais, Carol Sad, and Natalie Carrier. You know, I was just in Ottawa last week for the mayor's breakfast, and there is a lot of excitement in the air there for the Junos and for Ottawa 2017. So we're thrilled to be going back. Yes, Guy. As a not-for-profit, we really need the support of our partners, and we could not do any of this without them. So I just want to take a moment to acknowledge the financial support of Factor, the Government of Canada and of Canada's private radio broadcasters, the Radio Star Maker Fund, Ottawa 2017, the Province of Ontario, the Ontario Media Development Corporation, Ottawa Tourism, Google Play Music, who are back as our official streaming partner again this year, and our good friends at TD Bank, who have been longtime supporters of the Junos and MusiCounts. You know, connecting with brands and music is one of our strengths at CARAS, and this year we're really proud to be hosting the Canadian Sponsorship Forum Experience. CSFX, as it's known, will be embedding their conference right into Juno Week in Ottawa. They're going to have over 300 brands and agencies all coming together to talk about sponsorship and music. It's going to be a great opportunity for our industry, and we're thrilled to have them with us in Ottawa. Also, in honor of Canada's 150th and our return to the nation's capital, we decided it was time to bring back the Juno train. It's going to transport our nominees in style again this year, not only from Toronto, but also from Montreal. It's powered by Via Rail, and the Juno Express will feature an onboard experience, onboard food experience, I should say, by Metro Ontario, and an exclusive Virgin Mobile member lounge. Information on the Juno Express will be inside all the nominee packages. CARAS has also partnered with Toronto-based clothing company called Peace Collective. They've produced a Juno signature merchandise line, and it's launching today with the themes of Home in Canada, as you will see, as well as Canadian built. And our friends at Peace Collective are set up at the back of the room today, so make sure you stop by and take a look. It's also going to be available online at peace-collective.com. In honor of today's celebrations, our new partner, Jackson Triggs, have provided some delicious made-for-Canada mimosas. So I encourage everyone to stop by the bar and pick one up. We'll bring a toast to the nominees towards the end of the day. Okay, just before we get started on the nominations, I do want to make one more broadcast performer announcement. This group's unique mix of dance, hip-hop, and Indigenous music has made their album, We Are the Hallucination, one of the most critically acclaimed albums of the year. We are absolutely thrilled that A Tribe Called Red will be performing on April 2nd at the Canadian Tire Center. I saw them in this very venue about a month ago, and they put on a great show, so I can't wait to see what they're gonna do on the JUNO stage. All right, enough of the talking. Let's get on with it. Please, turn your attention to the screens, and join me in seeing the 2017 JUNO Award nominees.
Your 2017 JUNO Award nominees are Album of the Year, sponsored by Music Canada. Encore un soir, Céline Dion. Views, Drake. You Want It Darker, Leonard Cohen. Illuminate, Shawn Mendes. Starboy, The Weeknd.
Contemporary Roots Album of the Year, sponsored by National Arts Center. Corin Raymond, Casey and Clayton, Lisa LeBlanc, Matthew Barber and Jill Barber, William Prince.
Classical Album of the Year, Vocal or Choral. Orion Baroque Orchestra, Alexandre Wyman. The Trinity Choir, Daniel Taylor. Orchestre Symphonique de Montréal, Kent Nagano. Tapestry Opera, Griffin Trio, Elmer Eisler Singers. Toronto Symphony Orchestra, Toronto Mendelssohn Choir, Sir Andrew Davis.
Instrumental Album of the Year, Blitz Berlin, David Braid. Pugs and Crows and Tony Wilson. Sarah Neufeld, The Fretless.
Dance Recording of the Year, Adventure Club, Bit Funk, Jacques Green, Sean Frank, Zed's Dead.
Single of the Year, Wild Things, Alessia Cara. One Dance, featuring Wizkid and Kyla, Drake. Treat You Better, Shawn Mendes. Spirits, The Strumbellas. Starboy, featuring Daft Punk, The Weeknd.
Francophone Album of the Year, Fred Fortin, Karim Ouellet, CARAS, Laurence Narbonne, Yann Perrault.
Contemporary Christian Gospel Album of the Year, Jaylene Johnson, Manifest, Steve Bell, Tim Neufeld and the Glory Boys, Warren Dean Flandes.
Pop Album of the Year, sponsored by TD, Alessia Cara, Coleman Hell, Marianas Trench, Shawn Mendes, Tegan and Sarah.
Video of the Year, sponsored by Much Fact, exclusively funded by Bell Media. Kill vs. Mame, Claire Boucher, Grimes, Killa, Jody, Wee Wick and Skirlix, The Stranger, Justin Stevenson, Gord Downey, Light Spots, Martin C. Parizeau, Kate Renata, Red, featuring Yassine Bey, Narcy and Black Bear, Yassine Narcia Salman, A Tribe Called Red.
Classical Album of the Year, Solo or Chamber, Charles Richard Hamelin, Yanina Fielkowska, Matt Heimovitz, New Orford String Quartet, Stuart Goodyear.
Electronic Album of the Year, A Tribe Called Red, Bob Moses, Harrison, Holy Fuck, Kate Renata.
Recording Engineer of the Year, Andy Schoaf, Eric Ratz, George Ciara, Jason Dufour, Maddie Green.
International Album of the Year, sponsored by IDLA, Associated Label Distribution, Ariana Grande, Coldplay, One Direction, Rihanna, Sia.
Jazz Album of the Year, Group, sponsored by Stingray Music, Darcy James Argues Secret Society, Dave Young Quintet, Metalwood, Order of Canada Band, Quinson Natchoff's Flux.
Reggae Recording of the Year, Amoy, Blessed, Dubmatics, Esco Levy, Jay Cartier.
Breakthrough Artist of the Year, sponsored by Factor, the Government of Canada, Canada's private radio broadcasters, and Radio Starmaker Fund. Andy Schoaf, Jazz Cartier, Kate Renata, Ruth B., Tori Lanes.
Metal Hard Music Album of the Year, Annihilator, Despised Icon, Devin Townsend Project, Mandroid Echo Star, Protest the Hero.
World Music Album of the Year, sponsored by Canada Council for the Arts, Lorraine Klassen, Nomadica, Akabango African Orchestra, Sultans of String, Turquoise.
Rap Recording of the Year, Belly, Drake, Jazz Cartier, Tasha the Amazon, Tori Lanes.
Children's Album of the Year, Diana Panton, Katam, Raffi, Splash and Boots, Will Strote. Please welcome to the stage the chairman of CARAS, the JUNO Awards and MusiCounts, Mark Cohan.
Welcome, everyone. Let's hear it again for those first slate of nominees. Come on, let's hear it for them. Amazing. It is going to be fun in Ottawa. You know, last year I was a new guy up here on the stage, and with a little over a year under my belt at CARAS, I want to reflect for a moment on my experience with CARAS. You know, when people think about CARAS, and you heard a little bit from Allan about what we do, most of you naturally go to the JUNO Awards. And I can tell you we're so much more than that. I've really come to appreciate what we do for the music industry. Our 365-day year-round mandate is pretty simple. It's to educate, to develop, to promote, and really celebrate our Canadian artists and Canadian music. You know, whether it's our work on MusiCounts or the Allan Slate JUNO Masterclass or JUNO TV or the JUNO Awards, we really are here. The Academy is here to serve the music industry. And if I take a moment and I reflect on my time over the past year, put up your hands if you were at the JUNO Awards last year or you watched it on TV. Now, most of you, come on. All right, most of you watched it or were there. There was one moment for me that was defining, that sort of made the hair on the back of my neck, which I usually shave, stand on end. And that's when Lights got up on stage with that young MusiCount artist sponsored by TD, Sam Spensley. And it was pretty moving because Sam was a student who was bullied in high school, and she didn't break out of her shell until she got that guitar and music spoke to her. So when I think about music, when I think about CARAS, you know, that really represents the good work and the great work that CARAS does across this country. And for me, as we think about what this year means to Canada, that moment really reflects on who we are as Canadians. I think we are a people that are open, I think we are people that are caring, and I think we are people that are supportive. Now, as we go to celebrate in the nation's capital and celebrate our 150th year of Confederation, I don't want to make this a political speech, but as we look at what's going on the world stage right now, I think Canada's light has never shined more brightly. And we should be proud of the role that our Canadian music and our Canadian artists play in our nation's identity. We all have songs that resonate with us, all those great Canadian songs. For me, and this is going to age me a little bit, you know, the Guess Who's American Woman. I ended up marrying a woman from New York, so I didn't listen to that. Never play that song when you're in an argument around the house. New Orleans is Sinking by the Tragically Hip, or Tom Sawyer by Rush. All these Canadian songs make us stop for a moment and really reflect on what it means to be Canadian. So as we get ready to celebrate in the nation's capital, I want to encourage every one of you, everyone in the room, all Canadians who are watching online across the country on JUNO TV, to think about your musical moment and be proud of our artists, of our musicians, and of their music, and what it means to making the social fabric of our country stronger. So I want to thank our artists. I want to thank you for what you do for our country and how you make us proud to be Canadians. Thank you.
Now, Allan got to introduce a few artists. I get to do one right now. This is the fun part of the gig. This group is going to grace our stage at the JUNO Awards in Ottawa. They are 2014 JUNO Award winners. They had an incredible song this year with Spirits, which reached number one on the Billboard's Alternative Song Chart and went platinum in Canada. Some members of the band are here today. I'm proud, excited, and pumped to announce that the Strombellas are going to be joining us in Ottawa. Awesome, guys. Can't wait to see your performance. I want to thank you for coming out. I want to congratulate all the nominees, and we'll see you in Ottawa. Thank you.
Our dedicated Diamond partners for their ongoing support of the JUNO Awards. Bell Media, CTV, Jackson Triggs, Metro Ontario, PWC, Slate Music, SOCAN, VRL Canada. Thanks to all our partners for their ongoing support of Canadian music. Your 2017 JUNO Award nominees are Jack Richardson, Producer of the Year, A Tribe Called Red, Eric Ratz, Howie Beck, Ian Dasan, 1985.
Traditional Roots Album of the Year, Jenny Whiteley, Maria Dunn, 10 Strings and a Goatskin, The East Pointers, The High Bar Gang.
Artist of the Year, Alessia Cara, Drake, Leonard Cohen, Shawn Mendes, The Weeknd.
Jazz Album of the Year, Solo, Brandy Disterheft, Mike Jansen, Renee Rosness, Seamus Blake, Sharantha Bedigay.
Adult Alternative Album of the Year, Andy Schoaf, Basha Bulat, Gord Downie, Leonard Cohen, Wintersleep.
Classical Album of the Year, Large Ensemble, Jan Leszczycki, Orchestre de l'Académie Nationale di Santa Cecilia, Les Violons du Roi and Mathieu Lussier, Louis Lortie, Hélène Mercier, BBC Philharmonic, Steve Wood and the Northern Cree Singers, Tanya Tagak, Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra, Tafel Music Baroque Orchestra and Chamber Choir.
Indigenous Music Album of the Year, sponsored by Aboriginal Peoples Television Network, Bryden Gwis Kiwensi, Crystal Shawanda, Quantum Tangle, Sila and Rise, William Prince.
Adult Contemporary Album of the Year, Celine Dion, Chantal Kreviazek, Heather Rankin, Mark Masri, Sarah McLaughlin.
Blues Album of the Year, Colin James, Colin Linden, Paul Rennick, Sean Pynchon, Whitehorse.
Recording Package of the Year, Claire Boucher and Rankin, John Wellman, Chris Shepherd, and Joshua Geary, Jonathan Shedletsky, Isis Essery, and Jeff Lemaire, Justin Ellsworth and Dustin Rabin, Kareem Charlebois Zafira, Olivier Charland, and Scotty Cameron.
Alternative Album of the Year, sponsored by Long & McQuaid, Black Mountain, Dilly Dally, Grimes, July Talk, Weaves.
Country Album of the Year, Aaron Pritchett, Chad Brownlee, Dallas Smith, Gord Bamford, Jess Moskaluk.
Vocal Jazz Album of the Year, Amanda Tosoff, Barbara Lika, Bria Skonberg, Heather Bambrin, Matt Dusk and Florence Kay.
Group of the Year, Arkells, Billy Talent, Tegan and Sarah, The Strombellas, The Tragically Hip.
Rock Album of the Year, Arkells, Billy Talent, Monster Truck, Sam Roberts Band, The Tragically Hip.
Songwriter of the Year, presented by SOCAN, Donovan Woods, Gord Downie, Leonard Cohen, Ruth Burhey, Tegan Quinn and Sarah Quinn.
Breakthrough Group of the Year, sponsored by Factor, the Government of Canada, Canada's private radio broadcasters, and Radio Star Maker Fund. Bleaker, Bob Moses, Cold Creek County, The Dirty Nil, The Zolas.
Classical Composition of the Year, Anna Sokolovich, Andrew Staniland, Christos Hatzis, Jordan Nobles, Kati Agosh.
R&B Soul Recording of the Year, Daniel Caesar, Division, Party Next Door, Tanika Charles, The Weeknd.
JUNO Fan Choice, presented by TD, Alessia Cara, Belly, Drake, Headley, Justin Bieber, Ruth B, Shawn Mendes, The Strumbellas, The Weeknd, Tory Lanez. Please welcome to the stage the president, broadcasting and content at Bell Media, and this year's recipient of the Walt Grealis Special Achievement Award, Randy Lennox.
Good morning, everyone. Anyway, I'd like to share Allan's congratulations to all of our incredible nominees, and also point out that this is our 16th year together as CTV and the Junos, a partnership that's been absolutely extraordinary. And I just want to thank Allan Reid for his great leadership of CARAS. I don't think we stop and acknowledge Allan often enough. So let's hear it for Allan. I think also Mark has been a fantastic, he stepped in his chair, as he said a year ago, and he's been extraordinary in adding great value and new thinking as we grow the Junos for the future. So, thank you, Mark. Also, I'm very honored that Allan called me for the Walt Grealis Award this year. And I just take a moment, for those of you that don't know, Walt Grealis himself invented the Junos. He started it with his mother and his aunt making sandwiches almost 50 years ago, and here we are today. So for Walt Grealis, it's a great legacy for him, and he was a great industry builder for us. One more thank you, and that's to our partners at Inside Productions. John, Barb, and Lindsay are extraordinary at producing this show, have done for decades, always keeping it fresh, always keeping it vibrant. So thanks, Insight, for stepping in for another year. And the only thing I'd like to add is another performer that we're announcing, fresh off Saturday Night Live this weekend with a phenomenal hit, Scars to Your Beautiful. Of course, I know that song. And I'd like to add Alessia Cara to our list of performers this year for the Junos. Anyway, with that, we'll see you all in Ottawa. Cheers.
Thanks very much, Randy. Well, listen, everybody, there you have it. The nominees for 2017. Please make sure you head over to the bar and make sure you get one of these lovely Made for Canada mimosas from our friends at Jackson Triggs. Please, if you wouldn't mind, raise a glass in honor of our nominees this year. Congratulations and good luck. Thanks very much for coming out today, everybody. We're looking forward to seeing you in Ottawa, April 2nd for the big broadcast. If you are a nominee, please make your way to the red carpet over there. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day. We'll see you soon.
So that was Allan Slate, and that was all the JUNO nominees. Welcome, JUNO heads, JUNO files. Is there like an official name for JUNO fans? Does anyone know? Let's go with JUNO heads. If you identify in a particular way as a fan of the Junos, tweet at JUNO Awards and let us know sort of what you want your suggestion to be. JUNO Knots is a suggestion that has come through from Kellen, who is operating the teleprompter. So yeah, please let us know how you identify. Maybe it's some weird thing, like the way that, you know, Jimmy Buffett fans are parrot heads. What an exciting list of nominees. There's some really interesting facts about this year's nominees. 183 overall, 41% of them are first-time nominees. And I think that that's really exciting. And even more exciting is that 74%, I was off by one, are all independent. So of those 183, 136 nominees are independent. And I think it's a great sign of the, you know, overall health of our amazing music scene in this country. And for the first time in 6 years, there is a woman nominated in Rap Recording of the Year, and that's Tasha the Amazon, who, a little inside baseball here, is in fact managed by someone that I work with. I won't say his government name. I don't know what his sort of priors look like. But I believe our first guest, and we're going to be here forever, interviewing all of the nominees that are here in Toronto at REBEL on this beautiful set, care of, you can see the thing here, Ontario Media Development Corporation. Thank you to the OMDC for perfectly recreating my parents' basement from the 80s. Like, this is literally how I grew up. In fact, there's this tiny touch back here of a literal photo of me as like a really cool grade 9. That photo is actually from band camp, and I'm hard posing with a crash cymbal because I played percussion. Amongst those first-time nominees that we were talking about, everyone who is nominated in Video of the Year category is in fact a first-time nominee, and that is super exciting. Metalwood, who were nominated for Jazz Album of the Year, were first nominated 19 years ago for their debut album. So I think that's the most like impressively decade-spanning nominee. And I know that a video promoting this stream got retweeted a lot by like a Justin Bieber fan account. And so I want to let all you Biebs heads know, what are the Bieber fans called? Beliebers. There we go. Justin Bieber has won the Fan Choice Award every year he's been nominated, which was 2011 2014 and then 2016. I don't know why he fell off in 2015. I guess it was just a tough year. Was that the year that he was like peeing in buckets and crashing cars and stuff? I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about all of Justin Bieber's troubles because he's nominated for these awards. Thanks for getting it together, Justin Bieber. So our first guest today is Weaves, who were nominated for Alternative Album of the Year. If they want, yeah, come hang. Hey, how's it going? Good to see you guys. Good to see you. How's it going? Good to see you. Sit down on my parents' couch, basically. Grab a microphone. You can hold on to your mimosa.
I
don't mean to be rude right out of the gate, but like you guys both have mimosas.
Yes.
What's wrong with this pic? No, I'm not going to take your mimosa.
Have some.
I'll have a sip, though.
It's
thank
nice.
You so
have
much.
A little sip.
So congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
Cool.
It's exciting.
That's a good mimosa.
It's pretty good, right?
What would you say is better, the nomination or a mimosa in the morning?
Oh, it's tough.
The nomination, not 100%.
Yeah,
yeah, it's awesome.
I mean, better than a mimosa is high praise, I think, for anything.
Yeah.
So that's great.
It's exciting.
Now, have you guys already texted someone? Have you let anyone know? Like, who was your first missive to?
I think we told our... Well, I told my mom.
I just called my mom.
Yeah.
Yeah, our moms
and
are
And what were your
exciting.
Respective moms' reactions?
Oh, my mom's all about it. She was like, ooh, Dilly Dally Grimes you. This is exciting.
my mom, what was her reaction? I think it was,
oh, that's good. That's great.
Kind of thing. And then a bunch of words afterwards.
Yeah.
You know, but that was the initial.
Also, I love how down your mom is. Like, I think, like, for some moms, like, I know you talk to people who are nominated, and it's like, oh, I finally get it because, like, I'm familiar with the Junos because, like, Drake is nominated. But
yes.
Your mom's like, oh, Dilly Dally. Like, I'm
she
so
was excited for, like, I think people that she knows.
Yeah, I guess.
And I didn't even know she really knew Grimes, but I guess she's all on. Yeah,
mom's
she's
got excited.
She's heard you talk about Grimes or something like that, and that's how she knows?
Yeah.
She's excited.
So I didn't realize, you know, from sort of, like, reading about the band, there's a bit in your bio about the idea that, like, this all kind of started as, like, iPhone, like, note demos. And then to be here is kind of remarkable. What were those initial, like, going into your phone demos like?
Pretty primitive.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just loop loop my own weird little melodies.
Yeah.
So it's kind of funny to be here today.
They're sometimes hard to decipher.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's figure this out.
It's,
exactly.
Honestly, it's like a puzzle or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it is strange to be here. Yeah. I don't know. My brain is a bit right now.
Yeah. And who are you? You know, there's a lot of celebs that are part of the Juno thing. Is there anyone that you guys are particularly excited about trying to like rub shoulders with? Like at the actual Junos or here today?
At the Junos, we were just talking about Sarah McLachlan.
Oh, yeah.
Humongous.
Yeah.
Amazing
Sarah McLachlan
human.
Fan.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fumbling Towards Ecstasy was one of my go-to records growing up because my sister was really into it.
Mm.
Oh, yeah. I'm a surfacing man myself.
It's beautiful as well.
But they're both incredible records.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
I had the immense pleasure of producing a show that she was performing at in December, this Christmas show. And so at one point during the day, she was sound checking and it was just like empty Massey Hall with all these Christmas trees and Christmas lights, and she's just like humming at the piano, and I was like, I'm weeping. Music is so beautiful.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
it
was.
Apparently, she's really cool too.
Yeah, she's down, man. Yeah. She's like really nice.
Lilith Fair.
I know, right?
You have to be cool to start that.
You have to be cool to start.
I would
Lilith
say,
Fair. Guys, congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you.
Thank you for the sip of the mimosa. I want to say that was classy. And I believe Ashley, you're gonna go over here and get your photos taken.
Okay.
And you know, drink mimosas until you know they kick us out.
All right.
Congratulations, guys.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Nice to see you.
Congrats, guys. So up next, we have Brendan Gwiss-Quinzy, nominated for Indigenous Music Album of the Year. Come on in. Come on. How's it going? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Take a seat, grab a microphone. So a big surprise, I mean, you were here, so I guess it's not too surprising. You must have suspected something was afoot.
Yeah, kind of. Like, my person that recorded me, his name is Robert Todd, Tribal Spirit Music. And he told me that we were just waiting for an email from the Junos.
Yeah.
So we were just like waiting until finally last week I came down to Toronto and we're on our way to Regina. And he gave me a message on Facebook and he said that the Junos got back to me and come to the ceremonies for today. And here I am.
And he's like, okay, I think I know what's happening
here.
So have you made any calls yet? Have you sent any texts? Have you sent any tweets?
Just a couple of them just for today.
Yeah.
Because I got the news on a few days ago, right? But I didn't want to post about it, not till after today.
Yeah, you wanted to keep it secret.
So
keep it safe.
I did say I had some news on Facebook, but I didn't say anything.
Now you can,
Now I can just go tell everyone.
Now, your grandfather was a champion fiddle player.
Yeah, is this Ricky.
So that's, okay, so like, you come from obviously like a very musical family then.
Yeah. Like all my aunties, uncles, they all play instruments, pianos, anything you name it. Like they play it.
Yeah.
Performers, So like music is in my blood too. So I've been like singing powwow, so like native style. And I incorporated like, I always made hip hop beats, right? But I didn't know what to do with it. So I added hip hop beats with my native singing and it's a combination of that. And I did really good this year, so.
Yeah. Was there a lot of pressure then, sort of growing up in a musical family, to, you know, also embrace that?
Like, I wasn't really too close with my family. I just knew that they were all into music.
Yeah.
And I just knew that I love music. It was in me. Ever since I was like 4 years old, I made my first little song on a keyboard called Baby Don't Die. It was just two little...
Sorry, Baby Don't Die?
Baby Don't Die.
You were a dark kid, eh? How old were you?
I was like, Baby Don't Die and Baby Don't Cry. It's just like a little back
good,
and forth.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was just only 4 years old, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's exciting. So 4 years old and now here on this beautiful set. Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
This is all new to me, so I'm just... taking it all in.
Awesome. Well, congratulations. Go over here. We got people taking your photo, getting Polaroids strung up, and you know, enjoy the day. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Cheers.
Take care.
I'll take this guy.
All right,
thank you. And up next, we have Tasha the Amazon, nominated for Rap Recording of the Year. How's it going? Good to see you.
Likewise.
Cheers. Got microphones. How's it going?
Pretty good.
So congratulations.
Thank you.
I want to do a little bit of like inside baseball, sort of necessary housekeeping, which is that I work with Erickson.
Yes, you do.
And so like a couple of days ago, he found out that you had been invited to this and he was like, I wonder if that means that. And I had to like, cause I've signed an NDA and all this stuff. And he was like, so what do you think that means? And I was like, it means nothing. It means nothing at all. And then he was like, are you trying to wink at me or something? And I was like, no, I'm not doing anything.
It's been happening all week for all of us.
Yeah, I just loved, I was like, maybe they just want to give you guys mimosas or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
At the very least, we get a free breakfast.
Exactly. Now, like, really looking at the category, though, like, that is some, like, household name heavy hitters.
Yeah.
And then you guys are like kind of the upstart, ostensibly, in that category, right?
I think that might be true for anybody who's not from Toronto.
Right.
Like
yeah.
at home. Like that list is very much, I mean, we've been talking about it for a long time. Toronto is kind of like mm-hmm. the epicenter of the world in terms of rap is concerned right now.
Yeah.
Like, so anyone in Toronto kind of, you know, knows me, knows Chaz, knows all obviously all the rest of the guys.
Yeah.
It's just really cool that the rest of the country gets to see it too.
Yeah, understanding that like that is the plane that you are yeah. operating in for sure.
Yeah.
And in addition, obviously, you know, to your skills with the microphone, you guys also produce everything, like everything on the record, right?
Yeah. That's
right. How important is that to sort of maintain complete control of the entire package of what you guys do?
For me, it's like, it's essential. I started producing because, you know, just collaborating with other people who were producing mm-hmm. and I was young and I didn't really know how yet.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard if you have a vision and
yeah.
like, you know, you want to sound a specific way and like trying to communicate that to somebody else is really difficult. So Danthrax and I, you know, came up with an entire sound and developed what we do. And so now it's really hard to actually collaborate with another mm-hmm. producer because we've kind of honed it down.
So much. There's so many talented people in the city who are trying to produce and like, we just kind of had to do it our own way.
Mm-hmm.
But before too long, I think that's one of the reasons why the project probably caught some attention, because it really is our own thing.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. Awesome. Well, guys, congratulations on the nomination. Congratulate Erickson as well.
I will.
And,
probably four mimosas deeper.
He's yeah, yeah. I texted him and I was like, congrats, man. He was like, mimosas at the office.
Yes.
So like, by the time I see Erickson at 2 p.m. back in our office,
oh,
like,
he's
he will
gonna be lit. It's going to be lit. Yeah.
He'll be in it pretty deep. Yeah,
yeah. Totally.
Congratulations,
awesome.
Guys. Enjoy the day.
Nice meeting you.
Cheers. Congratulations, guys. Thank you kindly. So up next we have Paul Reddick and Sean Pynchon, nominated for Blues Album of the Year. So guys, come on in. How's it going?
Sean Pynchon.
Nice to meet you, Pynchon. Sam. Okay. Hey, how's it going?
Paul.
Sam. Come on in, make yourself at home, grab a microphone.
Right.
We got, we're like the full sort of like parent, sort of parent level of things.
Oh, I like this.
Which is, yeah, it's pretty good.
Beautiful set too.
So have you guys like texted like, families and stuff yet?
I told my ex-girlfriend, and I put it on Facebook just now. So.
Told your ex-girlfriend, like, just to stick it to her, or
because
you guys are friendly?
Yeah, we're friendly, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
She's the closest I have right now.
That's good. And what about you? Have you, like, texted any exes?
I haven't yet.
You're not?
They're already here.
Oh, okay. Congratulations yeah. on that. So, I loved in your bio, like, for some reason you have self-described yourself as a typical ginger.
Yeah.
And I want to know, like, what does typical ginger mean?
A little bit of a hot head at moments, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm very sweaty.
Sweating is, like, part of the ginger lifestyle.
I perspire quickly, and I rot through things. High acidity, pH balance, you know, that kind
yeah,
of thing. Destroy
okay.
guitar strings.
I didn't realize that the high acidity in
yeah.
the sweat was, like,
Celtic blood,
part of the...
burns
just
through.
Burns
genes
right there.
Or
you're like
more,
the alien.
Yeah, basically. I'm
okay.
like my xenomorph. Yes.
Yeah.
Like that.
That's exciting. And Sean, you were probably the only person here maybe who has had a song in a Super Bowl ad. Is that... Coca-Cola commercial in a Super Bowl ad. Do you lead with that when you meet new people? Like, hi, I've had music in a Super Bowl ad. You mind throwing the mic up to your... The people can't hear what you're bragging about. Do you have a microphone over there? Oh, yeah. Sorry, what were you saying?
No, I don't. I forgot about it till you mentioned it.
There you. I'm here to remind... I guess, you know, Super Bowl is sort of fresh in my mind.
That's true.
And so I wanted to jog your memories.
No, it was probably 10 years ago, maybe.
Oh, okay, yeah. So this is like... old bragging. 10 years ago, yeah. though, did you brag a lot about it? Is that...
Well, you know, people talk about it. No, I didn't personally.
Yeah. That's good.
Modest.
I appreciate that. Now, I assume because you guys are up together, this means you would be pulling for each other in this category.
Yeah, absolutely.
But if one of you, if neither of you could win, who would you sort of want in the blues category to sort of rise up?
Out of the nominees?
Yeah, out of the nominees.
Paul and James and Paul and Lyndon need a helping hand.
I would
yeah,
say,
you
yeah,
think they really,
I would say that
so nice.
I've learned so much from stealing stuff from Paul and Lyndon's records that, like, you know, I would be rude for me not to say him.
Yeah,
you know?
Because you've stolen
I've been
everything
ripping,
from
him. And then the album they did together, National Steel,
yeah.
that was, like, the first
yeah.
slide album I ever owned, and I learned that song or that album. Like, that was, yeah, that was my introductory to blues guitar, basically. So
awesome.
Paul and Lyndon produced... four records for me, so we're very good friends.
Oh,
yeah. Awesome.
Beautiful man. Nice beard, too.
Ooh, yeah, okay. What do you think his sweat's like, though?
It's probably not as bad as mine, but it's hard to tell.
Yeah, it's hard to know, right?
Yeah, I don't really know. I mean, I love to be somebody that sweats as bad as I do, especially when they're on, you know, under duress.
Yeah, yeah, it make you feel a lot better.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
Like, oh,
yeah.
Birds of a feather, it's nice.
Yeah, it's, you know, Scotland.
Awesome. Well, guys, congratulations
Thank
on
you.
The nominations.
Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for your time. Enjoy the rest of the day here. Down by the beautiful waterfront here,
yeah, no, totally.
Here at REBEL. And I want to say thank you again to the Ontario Media Development Corporation for bringing my parents' entire bedroom here for us
to
enjoy.
This is really like the greatest
great?
Thing I've ever been to.
Yeah, isn't it awesome? Yeah. I walked in this morning, or Jill from the Juno sent me a text last night. It was like, here's your set. And I was like, this is tight.
Yeah, this like, is like kind of stuff that you pay chic amounts of money for.
Yeah, 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 exactly, like, yeah. No, it's good to be sort of sitting this wealthy down here. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Oh, thank you.
Take
thank you, guys.
Job,
cheers. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Grab a mimosa. They got all kinds of mimosas. Guys, I love hanging out here. I really feel extremely comfortable. Like, within 20 minutes, I'm going to be like, does this read as well on television, or does this look like a little too lazy? Okay, so right now we have Jay Cartier nominated for record Reggae Recording of the Year. Come on in. How's it going, man? Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Come on in. Grab a mic. Take a seat on what is definitely an exact replica of my parents' couch from the 80s.
Yeah,
congratulations.
Nice.
So who have you texted? Who have you called? Have you had a chance
Actually,
yet?
Actually, my publicist is handling the phone right now.
Okay, good.
I'm like, I'm too excited to just even
awesome.
Touch it, so I'm just here enjoying the moment while she does all that, the groundwork.
Awesome.
Right now.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, as a kid, you split your time between Kingston and St. Catharines, Ontario, right?
Yeah.
To me, like, that seems terrible because, like, St. Catharines, I'm sorry for all of our views on St. Catharines, and
St.
presumably
Catherine,
you had family
Jamaica.
There. Yeah, like, St. Catharines is like, nah, I mean, you know, it's fine. But Kingston seems like a much more, you know, exciting
well,
place.
It's, yeah. Kingston, that's where the life is at, though. That's where all the energy is. That's
yeah.
where you see a lot more things. St. Catharines is more quiet. It's like living in the suburb or
yeah.
in the country area in Canada. Like, nothing
yeah.
really happens. You just, huh? Cow tipping.
It's cow tipping? Yeah.
Exactly, right? So, yeah, and Kingston, that's where all the action is. And
yeah.
living in, like, inner city Kingston, there's
yeah.
a lot to experience. You see a lot of different things in your surroundings. So
mm-hmm.
it was a good experience to me, for both sides, actually.
So you experience all of that,
exactly.
the different ways, yeah.
yeah.
It seems like Reggae Recording of the Year as a Juno category is, like, there's a lot of the same names. People get nominated, like, 7 years in a row, like people
Correct.
Sort of. How do you feel about sort of being part of this
honored,
cohort?
Yeah, honored. Like you feel like now you're amongst
yeah.
the best that's recognized for doing reggae. So yes, it's
yeah.
a really good feeling.
Your publicist, yeah, yeah, yeah. the like, yeah, yeah. It's like someone whispering at me. I was like, no, it's your mic
yeah.
technique.
Yeah,
all
yeah.
right,
my mic.
Sorry, yeah.
Oh.
But sorry, you were saying, yeah, you get a sense of like.
Yeah, you just feel like a part of something bigger.
Yeah.
You feel a part of the community now, right?
Mm-hmm.
So all the big names that's been nominated, now you feel like you're amongst them or you're making your way towards that.
Yeah.
And that's a goal of mine.
Do you have a favorite artist in the category yourself or someone, if you couldn't
well,
win, someone you'd be like, oh, they'll be fine losing to
you
them?
You know what? I don't want to, because I'm friends with most of these people.
Yeah,
I don't want to.
Yeah, you don't
want to
pick
any.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Wanna, yeah
Who
like,
do you hope doesn't win? Who would you be mad if they won? Where you're like, I don't like that guy.
No comment. Set me up.
Yeah, you know, that's good. That's very diplomatic. That will take you very far.
All right, thank you.
Awesome. Congratulations on the nomination.
Much.
Enjoy the rest of the day.
You too.
So up next, we have Turquoise nominated for World Music Album of the Year. Come hang in the 80s. How's it going?
Good.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Hi.
Congratulations.
I'm Brenna.
I'm Miriam.
Nice to meet you, Brenna and Miriam. Take a seat. Grab a mic.
We're in a group.
I got see it's a oh well now it's
oh.
gone but
oh,
it told I said it
oh you said it
yeah
oh,
yeah yeah
cool.
it happened but you know guys congratulations on the nomination
thank you
this is exciting this is sort of my default first question for everyone but like have you texted anyone have you called anyone
oh yeah
yes.
who is your first like message to
well we have two other bandmates so I
oh yeah and they're not here so you
no.
have to let
yeah.
them know okay
yeah.
And then
general sort of
Instagram,
friends
Facebook.
And followers.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, friends and followers. Okay, that's exciting.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who do you think is the most excited out of? Because there's four of you guys,
yeah.
right?
I think Miriam is like.
Yeah.
Like,
okay, you're the one. Okay.
She's got little sort of fire sparks
yeah.
coming out
oh,
of
yeah.
her head. The rest of us are a little more cool water,
yeah.
but
yeah.
you know.
Can you tell me a little bit about, because there's this like real like dazzling array of sort of cultural influences that you guys are pulling on.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like an alphabetical list of, I'm like, this is a lot of stuff. So tell me a bit about what has drawn you to the kind of music that you've, you know, incorporated into your own sound?
Well,
each of us has a long story, actually, yeah. I can say. So, but for all of us, it has to do with experiencing other cultures, whether they came from our family, like in the case of Miriam, who has like Egyptian background and so has that whole cultural heritage to draw upon, or more in the case of Jane and myself, you know, we're sort of white bread, but we got really interested in other cultures, and it took us a long, you know, we've spent a long time not just learning the music, but learning the languages, the food, you know, everything else that goes along with it. So,
awesome. Well, hopefully you can treat yourself to maybe one of the foods tonight as a congratulatory dinner. But congratulations on the nomination,
guys.
Thank you
so much. Thank
you. Cheers. You can go over there and they're taking photos of everybody and throw the mics down and, you know, next person gets to sit on it.
Thank you.
Congratulations, guys. I do we have any suggestions yet for new Juno Juno heads? How's it going? Congratulations. How's it going, Sam? Take a seat, grab a microphone. Hey, how's it going, man? Sam.
How you doing, man?
So, guys, congratulations on the nomination.
Thanks.
It's cool, right? So every time, like, I have anyone in common with anyone, I always like to do, like, an inside baseball thing first, which is Donnie Cooper, I believe, did he sound for you guys, or he TMs you,
or
a little bit of everything, and Donnie Cooper recorded the first EP from, like, a band that I am in that is, like, not as popular as your band and hasn't been nominated for a Juno. But he's, like,
What band?
Like, it's called Junior Battles.
Okay, cool.
Great
punk band,
guys. Denied Juno nominees. It's quite upsetting.
Donnie does good work.
Donnie is great because in a world that is, like, so, you know, like, this is a very progressive kind of culture that we have in sort of Canada's music community, and Donnie is the biggest troll I've ever met in my life.
He is.
So this guy, like, you know, constantly is wearing, like, America-themed clothing.
Yeah.
His Instagram account is mostly, I think, designed at, like, trolling.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it is him.
Yeah.
It's interesting lately because things have gotten a bit too real for him.
I think that's what I wonder is, like, now it's not as funny,
he's kind
right?
of backed down a little bit.
Yeah.
It's getting too real for him. So.
You just get too close to the edge for Donnie Cooper. Stuff. So with this album that you guys are nominated for, you talked a little bit about wanting to sort of make something that was more organic. You know, I read some stuff about wanting to kind of go back a little bit to, like, the roots of the band. Can you tell me a little bit more about the decision to go that way and sort of how that process affected the album?
I think we were able to do, like, an organic live recording this time because we were very well prepared. We had every part worked out.
We had,
you know, kind of signed the dot of the I's and crossed the T's with all the tunes, so we could perform it very well.
We had a lot of rehearsals going into it, and, like, had tons of songs going into it, and also, like, we recorded it in Halifax at the same place that we recorded
first three records,
so, like, it kind of felt almost like
you're tapping into that part of the band.
Exactly, yeah.
Are you traditionally not that prepared when you go in? You're like, we could actually play this album.
Yeah, well,
like,
I just say that because the previous two records, Hello Hum and New Inheritors, they were more of studio projects.
Yeah.
Kind of, you know, from the
you build that way.
In
the
studio.
It's a different process.
So this time it was more about capturing the band.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Just taking a snapshot of it as opposed to using the studio less as an instrument and more as just,
like,
a
tool.
Totally. Yeah,
yeah, exactly.
A capturing device.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, guys, congratulations on the album. Congratulations
Thanks.
On the
Cheers,
nomination.
Sir.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Cheers. Cheers, guys.
Awesome. Thanks.
I'll just throw them down. I don't have no use for those microphones anymore. Yeah, it's going to be good. Cheers, guys. So up next, we have the Sultans of String, who were nominated for World Music Album of the Year. Come on in. The Sultans. Come hang. Yeah, come join. How's it going? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
congratulations.
You.
Hey, congratulations.
Hey, thank you very much.
Hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, here you guys can squeeze in on the couch,
share
some mics. I like that you came, like, immediately ready to rock.
He's prepared.
Yeah.
With his guitar, just in case you never know what happens.
You gotta be ready.
Jamming at the Juno.
Yeah,
it's like,
exactly.
Bonfire.
There are a lot of musicians, Like, it does seem...
we're trolling for gigs.
You're gonna be out there busking at the end and be like, oh, I'll throw a dollar or whatever. It's nice.
Yeah.
Amen, a dollar's a dollar.
A dollar's a dollar. So congratulations on this nomination. And this record, you guys have a cover of Blowin' in the Wind that is in... like English and Urdu, is
that
correct?
That's right, yeah, Bollywood style.
Right, pretty so awesome. Tell me about the concept of like, that was it that song, or did you know you wanted to kind of do a song in that style and you picked that song? Like, what was the first part of that process? Because that's a very interesting approach to a classic folk song.
The magic of this collaboration was that Anwar, our major collaborator on this project, comes from Pakistan, where he wasn't even allowed to play sitar. So he came to Canada as a place to find freedom, religious freedom, freedom to play music, freedom to be who he is. And when I discovered that that was a song that actually he had learned and played in Pakistan, I thought, you know, that's the power of a good song or a great song that transcends all boundaries, like religious, language, ethnic boundaries. And so we decided like we had to do some kind of version of it. So yeah, it's very Anwarized.
Yeah, it's very exciting. And do you think, I mean, just even in the way that you're talking about it right now, and we heard, you know, it was spoken about a little bit on stage, you know, that these are very trying and tragic times in the world for many reasons. And that's sort of the inherent message in taking the song in that direction, I think is a very kind of hopeful message maybe for people at this time. Is that fair to say?
I hope that Canada remains a beacon of light for the world. Like, I think that what we're doing, this this social experiment of inviting people from around the world to make Canada their home, I hope that people see what we're doing and that somehow it provides hope for all the displaced and all the people around the world who are feeling persecution right now, including our friends south of the border and our friends in the Middle East. So I think it's in some ways, like we're in Canada, we're lucky because we have the opportunity to model a way of showing world peace and coming together as people.
Yeah, that's a nice message. I hope that's the only thing that I have to talk about political in the next hour, because that was hopeful and good.
Yeah.
And I just want to leave it at that.
Hope.
Yeah, that's nice.
Hope over fear.
Congratulations on the nomination,
Thank
guys.
Thank you so much. Yeah, yeah awesome.
Cheers, guys. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, cheers, guys. And go over there and they're taking photos.
Okay.
Right. Go be like, you know, beautifully kept in history with the Polaroid camera. Thank you so much, guys. Cheers. So again, if you have a good name for what JUNO fans should be called, please tweet it at the JUNO Awards. JUNO Nonce is still my favorite, but like, feel free to go wild with it. Up next, we have Corin Raymond, nominated for Contemporary Roots Album of the Year. Come hang.
Hey, how you doing?
How's it going? Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, take a seat on my parents' couch.
This is your parents' couch?
This is my parents' couch, and grab one or both microphones.
Can I ask you, is the horse head trophy from your folks' place too?
Yeah, that's actually a bronze version of the first horse that I killed. So that's actually
beautiful.
That's actually a trophy from
Imagine
when I was
they were able to miniaturize it like that for you.
Yeah, no. Well, it was actually a baby horse.
Okay.
Because I was a child myself.
Oh,
but
man.
I was being raised to be a horse hunter.
Right, okay.
We're very rich.
Okay, which is illegal in some counties.
Oh no, we are so rich.
Yeah, yeah.
We kill stuff
That's
that
amazing.
You haven't even heard of, man. It's
and you
wild.
Do this just out of...
This is a hobby. Like, this is totally a hobby.
Labor
for
of love.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's awesome.
I know, it's inspiring. Congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask you about the Canadian Tire Money album, but
sure,
is that a
it.
Thing that
do
are
it.
You sick of talking about that, or is
well,
that...
Well, you know... That's like asking someone if they're sick of talking about that time they walked on the moon.
Okay, great. So I think, so for context, you funded an entire album.
Yeah,
with Canadian
yeah, double
Tire
album.
Money. Yeah,
the,
sorry, a
the
double
studio
album.
Studio bill, I'll tell you how much it was, because that'll make it more fun right away.
Yeah.
The bill that we paid with Tire Money was $7,333.75.
That's incredible.
It weighed 85 pounds.
Yeah.
And it'll never happen again. It was impossible, and we did it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not something that, like, other people have... sought to replicate. I mean, that's just...
No, well, I don't think anyone else would have. I think I was just the right guy, because I didn't think of any of it.
Yeah.
Like, it was just a bunch of random, sort of like a benevolent, perfect storm of circumstances.
Yeah.
And it was one of those things, you know, you drink with your buddies, and it's like, hey, man, we could fund this thing for Canadian Tire Money, and then you laugh, and then you forget about it.
And you're like...
But I was just like, what would happen?
Yeah.
Like, if we just didn't stop.
Yeah.
And people just kept having more and more fun, to the point where it was like, over a year... It gave people a reason to laugh, like, every day.
Yeah.
And it was outrageous. And it was a lot of work, but it was, like, a fun wave to ride. And I noticed that the Junos are at the Canadian Tire Center.
Yeah.
Which doesn't seem like coincidence
That's
to me.
That's not. You actually inspired, I believe I was talking to some of the Juno people earlier, and they said, in deference to your achievement, that's where they're going to be hosting it this year.
And all the horses that you've killed will probably be on display.
It's going to be, there's going to be a lot of horse heads and a lot of Canadian Tire money. It's going
to
be great.
I'm more excited now after talking to you than I was before.
Well, that's what I'm here for.
Yeah.
That's what I'm here for. Awesome. Congratulations on the nomination on this album that you paid for with normal money.
Thank you. Yeah, I know. It costs a bunch of normal money.
That's true. You should also listen to that album. Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Okay, man.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Go over, get your photo taken.
All right.
Cheers, man. So up next, we have Katam nominated for Children's Album of the Year. Come on in.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, take a seat, grab a microphone.
Yes.
So how has this day been for you so far?
It's awesome. It's my first album.
Yeah.
And I didn't expect it, so I'm really happy.
Yeah, so this is all a surprise. This is like a nice surprise. Have you texted anyone? Have you called anyone? Have you messaged anybody?
Yeah, of course.
You snap it? Did you Snapchat it?
No, I don't. Okay. I don't know that.
Yeah.
My co-producer and some friends. And that's it for now.
Yeah, wait, and like you got a whole day now to like sort of live on your phone.
And I want the toolkit. I want to do something nice, you know.
Now, do you do, I feel like I'd read this, like 200 shows a year, 200 shows last year.
How
like,
you know that?
It's, I mean, like I've had, I don't just sit here and ask people about Snapchat.
Okay.
I think it was like in a bio pack that I read.
Okay,
which is,
awesome,
you know,
awesome.
Yeah. So 200 shows last year?
Yeah.
That's like kind of like hardcore band numbers. That's like Henry Rollins getting the van numbers. Like, I don't necessarily associate that, like, grind it out, get in the van work ethic with, like, children's music albums. Uh-huh. So, like, tell me about that year of 200
shows. Yeah, I've been from Saskatchewan to Nova Scotia, touring mostly in schools.
Yeah.
And in Quebec, a lot of family venues.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, it was a big year. And at the same time, I released the album, so it was a lot of work. Yeah, I feel really lucky. Actually, my CD comes from the idea of the show, the live show.
Yeah.
I didn't expect to do an album at first, but after doing so many shows, I should make an album of it.
Yeah. Will you do it again? Like, will you do that same year again? Or is 200 shows in a year maybe too much?
No, it's not too much.
Yeah.
I like it. Now I have an album to sell. It's
better. You got a Juno nomination.
Exactly.
It's all pretty good.
You know what? I'm actually touring right now.
Yeah.
I'm in Toronto because I was supposed to perform in schools today, but it's canceled because of the weather.
Oh, yeah. Did it finally start raining? Because it was like not really. There was a lot of talk about freezing rain, and I drove here no problem, but maybe my car's in the lake. I don't know.
Yeah, me too.
It's terrible.
That's why I'm here today. Otherwise, I would have been just making shows in school today.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Well, I'm glad that worked out. That's very convenient.
I'm lucky. Yeah.
Awesome. Congratulations on the nomination.
Very nice.
Head over, get your photo taken. Juno peeps are taking pics. Up against the wall.
It's done? It's already done?
No. You're going to go over there. They're going to do it. They got to pull
over.
Right.
Okay,
yeah. Perfect. It's the way of like moving people off the set. Like,
okay, thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Thanks again.
Cheers, man. Have a good one. Okay, up next we have Warren Dean Flandes nominated for Contemporary Christian Gospel Album of the Year. So, come on. Come hang.
How's it going?
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Take a seat. Grab a mic.
Absolutely.
What do you think of this set?
It's awesome.
Isn't it good?
It reminds me of my parents' basement.
It's totally, like I sent, so Jill, who produces all the Juno TV stuff, I sent her a photo of my actual parents' basement. And like that thing over there with the trophies is almost identical to what was in my parents' basement, except there were absolutely no trophies on it. Like I've never won a trophy for anything in my entire life.
Well, you know, like all this stuff can be sold on Craigslist now for like a lot of money.
I know. Well, someone else said, was like, this set is like, vintage chic, right?
Yes,
like
I think mid-century.
It's very the Stranger Things vibe is hot.
Absolutely.
So congratulations on this nomination.
Thank you.
And I'd read that a part of this album, or sort of your process as an artist, was sort of rediscovering your church roots, like as a gospel artist. So tell me a little bit about that. What does that mean? What's that process been like?
I grew up singing in the church, and then went into music professionally after that, and I ended up doing R&B, soul, pop, in those genres that were really kind of more mainstream and accepted, you know.
Yeah.
And even R&B soul was like seemed to be a tough sell at that time for Canada. Everyone said, go to the States, go to Europe.
Yeah.
When I did the gospel album, which really was a labor of love, it just opened so many doors, and people thought I was absolutely crazy for doing it, but it was just, you know, it's from the heart, and it was something that I really wanted to share, and to be recognized today for it with the nomination is just truly humbling.
Do you think it's interesting that like when you take that route, when you say like, I'm really just going to do this thing because I love it, no other reason, and that's the thing that sort of gets you the Juno nomination and sort of, you know, really sort of gets recognition in particular?
Absolutely. I mean, I'm a firm believer that if it's not authentic, then it's not going to be translated well to your audience. You know, a lot of times you have so many cooks in the kitchen telling you what to do, you know, be the next Bruno Mars, be, you
yeah,
know,
yeah.
CeeLo Green. And
people are always telling me to be the next Bruno Mars.
I can see it.
I know. Can you tell?
You have a really high voice?
I was also a child Elvis impersonator.
Okay.
Which is actually how I got this job.
But fantastic.
I refused to wear the getup. So.
You should have an impersonator of the year category for the Junos.
I'm going to talk to somebody about that. Can someone talk to Allan and add impersonator of the year?
And you'll be up for it.
That'll be me. So next year you can interview. We'll swap for this section.
Okay, I'll be Lenny Kravitz.
Congratulations on the nomination.
So
head over there. They're taking photos of everyone. So just go over there and have a great day.
Thank you.
Cheers, man.
All right, take care.
Congrats. So up next we have Cold Creek Country nominated for Breakthrough Group of the Year, but I don't think you're in Cold Creek Country. Come on in, how's it going, man?
Good.
Sam, nice to meet you. Take a seat, grab a microphone. Let's do this. So I mispronounced this, I read this. Can you pronounce this for me?
This is Okavango African Orchestra.
Right, okay, so congratulations on this nomination.
Thank you very much.
And what is so interesting, I think, about what you guys did on this record is that it's a lot of different African cultures and instruments all being brought into one place.
Yes.
So can you tell me about the process of doing that? Because I guess I don't have a great frame of reference on this. So kind of like, explain it to me like I'm an idiot.
Yeah, no, it's okay. You actually generally have an idea of what happened.
Yeah.
So what happened was I identified musicians from different regions of Africa, who play traditional instruments that are synonymous with their music cultures.
Yeah.
So we got together and then we came up with songs. There's five composers in the project.
Yeah.
Who contributed two songs each that are traditional songs and they were playing their traditional instruments. So what happened is we got together and then we rehearsed together, initially trying to see how the instruments work with each
other. Because traditionally these instruments don't play together.
They don't play together traditionally. And some of them, like I played with instruments that I'd never had an opportunity to play with.
Yeah.
So that was my first time in the orchestra.
Which is so exciting.
It was really exciting. And everyone was outside their comfort zone, which is really good. It was challenging but nice. So we got to a process where we had to learn to work with each other. And another instrument needed time to be tuned to a different tune, we had to learn to be that patient so that we can work together well. So we rehearsed that and then we started rehearsing the songs. And we rehearsed the songs. That took quite some time as well.
Yeah.
Because, you know, each musician had to come and explain how the song would be played in their culture and how they would want it to be played, the different parts.
So it's also an opportunity to learn about those other cultures addition to the music.
Yeah, definitely it was an opportunity to learn from each other and learn from those cultures. So that's what happened. And then apart from just learning the instruments, we also had to sing like backup vocals for each other's songs. So we also had to learn a little bit of each other's language, just words.
Okay, yeah.
How to pronounce them well.
Yeah.
So we, that's how.
So how many languages are on this as well?
There is, let me.
You're going to count? Yeah, count.
I've got to count. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 languages.
Okay, so that's
a lot of languages too.
And are you functional now in all those languages? Like, can you like order a beer or find out where the bathroom is in those languages?
Well, not really.
Yeah.
Well, what we just learned with just the, you know, just a few greetings here and there, but mostly we learned the words that were in the songs.
Yeah.
Like the songs.
Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Well, congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you very much.
Okavango.
Okavango? Yeah, Okavango.
Okavango African Orchestra. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, cheers. Head over there. They're going to be taking photos of everyone as well.
Thank you very much.
Cheers. Just drop the mic. Leave it there. Thanks so much. Cheers. Up next, we have Cold Creek Country nominated for Breakthrough Album of the Year. No. Oh, what's... Oh, yeah, we got Coleman Hell. Yeah, hey, there we go. That makes way more sense. That's been up there. Coleman Hell, come on in. The Cold Creek Country is up next thing has been up for, wait, hold on, run it through Jill. Wait, what is Coleman Hill? Coleman Hill, yeah, we're good? Yeah, okay, great. Come on in. Okay, yeah. It's been very confusing up on this screen for a little while. How's it going?
Good. How you doing?
Congratulations. Take a seat, grab a mic. So how's your day been?
Well, I'm not usually up this early, so it's been a little bit, you know, groggy, but I get to talk to a lot of people.
Yeah.
I got a big nomination, so that's exciting.
Yeah, it's great, man. Yeah. Like, what has the last year of your life been like? Because, like, you have this single that just, like, explodes, and it's the thing that you always kind of, like, hope could happen, but then it's, like, actually happening, right?
Yeah, it's been pretty wild. The, like, the songs off this record have kind of, like, taken me all over the place. Before this album, I hadn't even really traveled very much, mm-hmm. and I got to, like, spend, like, tons of time in the U.S. last year, got to go, like, overseas, I got to tour and see all of Canada, mm-hmm. so, yeah, it's kind of taken me all over the place, so.
Yeah.
And, like, to sort of just have, like, my first record get nominated is pretty...
It's cool. It's pretty cool. What's been, like, the surprise highlight? Because you sort of always know that, like, you know, oh, it's going to be... Oh, hopefully I'll get an award nomination, and, oh, it'll be cool to, like, do this big open for this artist. But what's been, like, I didn't expect that this was going to be a perk of having a hit. Like better seats on airplanes?
I guess so. I don't know. That is a thing, but I don't know if I'm that excited about that.
More Twitter followers.
All that stuff's kind of cool. I think what I like is like just having the excuse to like go everywhere and like do exactly what you want to do all the time.
Yeah.
It's pretty sweet.
You get some freedom. Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah.
And what are you going to like take any time off and enjoy that freedom? Like, in 2017, or is it still like full on like grinding?
Yeah, I'm not a big time off person.
Yeah,
I'm kind of just working on a new record right now, so that hopefully by like springtime I'll have some new stuff to start putting out. So
yeah, awesome. Yeah. Well, okay, well, people can look forward to that. That's awesome.
Exactly, man.
Congratulations on the big year. Congratulations on the nomination.
Thanks.
Cheers. Head over there. They're taking some photos. Okay. And do we have Cold Creek Country? Is that what's there's just like a dying, we think that's what's happening. Can someone, so in the interim, maybe like if someone could figure out what is up. Are you, yeah, come hang. This is a confusing last 5 minutes of my life. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How has your day been?
My day has been good, man.
These are amazing, like, plugs that you have.
The Batman
like,
plugs.
The Batman plugs? Like, yeah, I don't know how, like, close we can get on the plugs, but, like, they're pretty good.
I don't know.
So what's the first person you texted? Who's the first person you called?
It was my band. I flipped a text to my band. I flipped a text to my wife. I sent a text to our producer.
Yeah.
The label.
But that was the order, right? Band first, then wife.
It was probably the wife first.
That's good. Yeah. I mean, but you tell the band that you texted them first,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yeah.
I love the idea that collectively you guys seem to be from, like, the smallest towns in Canada.
Absolutely.
Like, it's like if you add up where everyone's from, you have a town of like 3,000 people or something.
Yeah, my hometown of Hastings, Ontario, it's just a village, man. It's 900 people, believe it or not. But now I'm living here. I'm living in Toronto.
How are you liking it? How are you adapting?
I love it, man. It's a lot, you know, the culture's great, lots of great food.
Yeah.
Everything's right here. The label's here, so it all makes sense.
Are you worried it's going to mess up your songwriting vibe, though? Like, is it going to, like, totally, like, you're going to lose the magic, the small town magic?
No, man. Actually, the songs that I have cut on this record were wrote in the city. So
cool.
It's kind of cool. Our studio's out in Brighton, though. It's out in the middle of the woods, so the vibe's really cool.
So you can still kind of escape and you can still get out.
Yeah.
It seems like there's, like, Canada's been sort of slow in terms of developing, like, the sorts of audiences you see in the States for country music.
Right.
But it's really happening now, and you see it, like, you guys are really emblematic of that, of, like, fervent fans, like, hit songs. Do you see that change happening? Do you think that's sort of a fair assessment?
Absolutely. There's a lot of talent coming out of Canada right now, man, and it's already starting to translate, you know, across the world in North America and all that other stuff. So we're very fortunate. We had a really great breakout year in 2016.
Yeah.
Things are good, and the talent in Canada is just it's crazy good.
Yeah.
I love it. It's great.
Who's your favorite other person, like, nominated in the country category? You guys are breakthrough, but yeah.
Yeah, Aaron Perchette, man.
Yeah.
I love that guy. You know, I was just chatting with him before we did the interviews over here, but mm-hmm. I love that guy. He's got a great record. Our producer, Scott Cook, he produced Aaron's record as well. So, I'm glad to see that, people are still liking what everyone's doing. So, it's pretty cool.
Awesome, man. Well, congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks. And head over there. They're taking pictures, everybody.
Thanks a lot.
Cheers, man. So, up next, we have White Horse, who are nominated for Blues Album of the Year. But I'm looking around, and I don't see anyone in White Horse. I'm really throwing Kellen under the bus here in terms of what is being communicated right now. But I do see up at the front, I believe, we have, here we go. Barbara, so Barbara, you're here? Come hang. How's it going?
Good, man. How are you?
Good to see you, dude.
Good. This is Barbara Lee Cup for
How's it going?
Hi.
Barbara, have a seat. Congratulations on your nomination.
Thank you.
Now... I read in your bio that you... Oh, here, grab a mic. Because I don't have one, I feel like people are being very casual with the mics. It's like my mistake.
Oh, okay, because you have the clip in.
I know, I got the clip on, yeah. So I can, like, be free and, like, really, like, chill deeply.
I feel like this is more comfortable to me. Like, this is...
I'm not comfortable right now.
Like, this is, like, when you don't have something to hold, this is like holding a drink at the party.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's why.
Because like before I was like, where... Where
what do you
I?
Do? Yeah. I'm going to like, I got the iPad, like, so the iPad feels good. So you studied both, so you're nominated for jazz, vocal jazz. You studied at U of T both jazz and biology.
Yeah, human
which,
biology.
Yeah. Seemed like sort of competing interests or like, was it sort of good to have a balance between the sort of art side and the science
side.
Yeah,
it was good. I did it to be rebellious against my parents because they were too supportive of music.
Right, okay. And you were
and
like,
so
I will
to
not
really
have this.
Stick it to them.
I am not interested. Yeah.
Yeah, like, I'll show you. But no, I actually ended up liking it because jazz school in Toronto is so competitive. Mm. It's just good to put on a lab coat and get out.
Yeah, that's fair. That's like nice to get a little bit of both those things. Yeah. Well, congratulations on the first time nomination.
Yeah, thanks so much.
And congratulations on being able to do both, biology and jazz at the same time.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Nice meeting you.
Yeah, Barbara Lika, and you can go over there and get your photo taken against the wall.
Yay.
Cheers. So up next we have Splash and Boots nominated for Children's Album of the Year. Oh, no, that's not what's happening. Poor Kellen. Oh, it's Billy Talent, not nominated for Children's Album of the Year. How's it going? Congratulations. Yeah. Cheers. I know. Congratulations. This is not dissimilar to last year, and I will joke this again, so the people that are coming up next, Splash and Boots, nominated for Children's Album of the Year, their category ran right after Metal Album of the Year. So they were doing the nominees, and they were like, Metal Album of the Year, fuck the facts. And then it was like, Children's Album of the Year. And it was just, and then they also ran them back to back in the interview section. And it
That's
was like,
really funny.
It was very funny.
Wow.
Yeah, so congratulations on the nomination,
Thank
guys.
Thank you so much.
How's the day been so far? Have you guys enjoyed any of the like mimosas or muffins or coffee?
Nice coffee. I put too much cream in my coffee. I thought it was milk. So that kind of ruined it, but the muffin was good.
Nothing is
Great
worse
muffin.
Than getting too creamy a coffee, man. It really messes up
my
day. It's tragic.
I go for the milk in the coffee.
Yeah. Okay.
I thought it was milk, and I did my milk pour, which is that's going to be a stronger pour than if it was cream.
It's a different pour. It's a totally different technique. Yeah, it's terrible. So I love how on this record you guys have sort of had to come out and be like, we don't hate DJs, because you have this song, Louder Than the DJ,
right,
that's sort of about like rock culture. And I think there's a great quote that I saw, I think it was from you, being like, some of my best friends are DJs. But can you tell us a little bit about, I guess, the message of that song, not necessarily the anti-DJ, anti-dance music stance of it, but like, what that means to you?
The message was that rock and roll is still here, it's alive and well, mm-hmm. and it might be in the backseat right now, but it's there's something special that you just can't replace from going to see a band and being in a sweaty, mosh pit and in a small bar or club or wherever.
Mm-hmm. It's sort of especially if you grew up with it, it's like, that's always for me going to be the thing that like hits me in the guts.
Yeah.
And I'll be like, I still love this. Like, as much as I like listen to rap, I'm like, I still just kind of, I love guitars, man.
That's great. Cool.
I really love guitars.
Yeah, there's something about the rock band performance that, that's captivating and powerful.
Yeah. And you're also nominated for the Producer of the Year award as well, right? Is it gratifying to be sort of seen as sort of achieving something not just as a band, but also like in a sort of sonic realm
Absolutely,
as well?
Absolutely, yeah. This will be the third Billy Talent album I've had a hand in producing, and it's pretty amazing to be recognized for, you know, the amount of work that was put into this record, and I really do, you know, thank the industry for that. That's pretty amazing.
He really deserves it. Yeah. Like working side by side with him while he's been producing the record, he was spending, you know, 17 hours a day and 14 hours a day in the studio, like every day, like just really, really dedicating his entire life to a project. And he does that with all the production he works on, and it's well deserved. And that to me is the one I'm most proud of out of all of it.
That's awesome. Does he ever like lord it over you though? Like where he's like, hey, it'd be really nice if someone would get me a coffee because I've been here since 6 a.m.
No.
Stragglers.
No, I don't do that. But these guys hate me after we make records.
We get a couple of fights.
But obviously everything's good now and you wish him well in the category.
It's all right. Yeah, it's all worthwhile. It's just brotherly love.
Yeah, and you guys are like a little sort of old hands here. Like, you know, you guys have been to the Junos before. Do you still get excited? Does it still sort of like, you know, when you see, you know, your name like in those album categories, in the producer categories?
I'm kind of almost more excited about it now because I'm excited about I hope we go. Because it's a fun weekend and it's a fun party. And now I know like it might not happen again. And I appreciate it more, you know, that it comes a few years in between that you might get nominated because you released a record. So to me, I'm excited about it and really, really thrilled that you know, we're nominated.
Awesome. Guys, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Cheers. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Just throw them down on my parents' couch and then go over there. They're taking photos of all the nominees.
It's a nice
jukebox. I know, right? It totally works, right?
Like the whole living room.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, we're going to get it. I'm going to also look really cool, too.
All right.
Hold on. Feel like I nailed that. Big smile, big rock and roll smile. Yeah. Cheers, guys. Yeah, congratulations. So up next now, actually for real, we have Splashin' Boots nominated for Children's Album of the Year. Come on up, guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Take a seat, grab a mic. So I was joking with Billy Talent about interviewing you guys last year. So not only the interview, but the nomination. I will repeat this anecdote because I love it so much. You guys were the last nominee listed in the children's category.
I know.
And so it was like, Splashin' Boots, and there's this like cute picture of you guys in like your show outfits.
Yeah,
and this is like very endearing. And then it's like, Metal Heart Album of the Year.
Metal Heart.
Fuck the facts. And we're the first
Kill
band
all
nominated.
The animals. And Splashin' Boots are up.
Yeah, it was just like, it was great. And then I don't know if it was on purpose, but they like ran you guys back together, back to back in the air. In the interview as well.
Yeah, that's right.
And it was delightful. And I was like, Billy Talent, not a curse word, but like it's still like, but you guys are consistently in this. Yeah,
but you know what? Our shows are very
that's
similar.
Right. That's what we try to go
they have,
for.
They have like the, you know, the mosh pit. We have a kitty mosh pit that happens during our shows. So
there you go.
It's not that far off.
Congratulations on the nomination.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
I really wanted to ask you guys a little bit about the like philanthropic efforts that you've undertaken.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's been in the last year. That's sort of been an ongoing part of what you've been doing, but just tell me a little bit about it's Camp Ooch. Camp Ooch.
Yep.
Yes.
So that's sort of part of it.
Yep.
But what are the sort of philanthropic efforts that are a part of Splashin' Boots? Yep.
So we work a lot with sick kids hospitals across the country, and we've been doing a lot with Camp Ooch, which is the camp for kids with cancer in Toronto, and it's amazing. It's the most amazing organization. So we visit there regularly. We're hoping to go up there and film with them in the summer.
Mm-hmm.
We also work with Northern Canadian communities, doing outreach programs with them. We're working on music programs for their summer day camps, which is really exciting.
Yeah, we just did a national tour, and we donated $1 from every ticket sale to this program that we're going to do starting like the next couple of months,
going
up to the Northern community. So, we have a sick kids visit on Thursday. So.
And was that always when you guys sort of wanted to, you know, or this project started as a Queens project, right?
Yeah.
But did it start always with wanting sort of philanthropy to be at the core of it? Or as you found more success, obviously, and then did you realize it was an opportunity to sort of get more involved?
I think we've always thought about it. We've been doing the sick kids hospitals for years and years and years.
Mm-hmm.
But now that when we go to visit sick kids hospital, they're watching us on TV already. So we get there, and it's like, you know what I mean? So we're
it's
using our...
to use what we've already got.
Yeah.
So it's always been about kids as it's opposed about kids. To about performing.
Yeah.
That's always what it's been about for us. So I think that it's exciting now that we have like an extra level to kind of do good things in the world.
We got the platform now, so we got to use it.
That's really exciting.
Yeah.
And very noble. I have a platform, and I've so far used it to ask people what fans of the Junos should be called. I like played with the stereo.
I love what you've done with the place this year, though. This is cool this year.
Yeah, isn't this sick? No, that's awesome.
It's very nice.
I know. Thank you too. The OMDC, good tie in there for.
You guys are awesome.
I know, it's fun. Well, guys, congratulations on the nomination.
Hey, good to talk to you again.
Yeah, good to see you guys again. Yeah.
Cheers.
Hopefully,
buddy.
See you guys in Ottawa.
Yes,
yeah.
You bet.
Yeah. Cheers.
Sure.
All right, so up next we have Heather Brambick, nominated for Vocal Jazz Album of the Year. Come on in. Bring your bags in. Make it. I think so. I mean, I think it sort of adds some color.
Absolutely.
Cheers. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Take a seat.
Absolutely.
Grab a mic.
Absolutely.
How's your day going?
Well, pretty darn good.
It's been good?
Yeah, it's been pretty darn good, I got to say.
Yeah, who was your first phone call, your first Snapchat, your first... messenger message to
my partner at home and my parents in Newfoundland and the guys in the band.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who was the most excited? If you could rank reactions, which one did you
my
feel
dogs,
like that was?
My dogs actually right now are on
dogs.
Facebook. I'm not even kidding
really?
You, Sam. No, absolutely. Muffin and Digby
Muffin
are at
and
home.
Digby.
Yeah, they are at home right now, and they are wearing. Oh. Muffin is wearing her fancy sweater with pearls, and Diggy has a bow tie on right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
That is, what kind of dogs are Muffin and Digby?
Muffin is a cockapoo. She's a rescue, and Diggy is a Yorkshire Terrier.
Okay. And sorry, are these photos also like on your Facebook page? Like
they
if people
are on
go
my
to
Facebook
your
page.
Facebook page.
If you go to my Facebook page, you can see my dogs all dressed
excellent.
Up.
Okay, that's good motivation. That's good like plugging for the Facebook.
Oh, it's all about the social media dog outfits. Absolutely.
Now, in addition, obviously, to your musical performance, which you are nominated for this year, you also do voiceover work as well,
I
right?
Do.
You do sort of animated films, you do commercials,
Look
right?
At you research.
Someone else
Look
said
at
that.
You.
Was like, wow. I can't believe you did. I was like, again, you know, I'm not just here because I'm quite beautiful.
Well, and he is. Very much
I know.
So.
Thank you so much. is that like another interesting way? Like, obviously, you have a talent with your voice. When did you realize you wanted to sort of go beyond just sort of singing and express that in different ways?
When I realized what I could make as a jazz singer.
Yeah, there you
right?
go.
And then I went, okay,
well,
someone's going to need to supplement.
Yeah.
You know, it was just something a friend of mine, my agent is started as a friend, and she said, well, do you want to get into this? And so it started with commercials, and then animation just kind of happened. You know, you do little funny voices, and then as a singer, you use your ear to mimic things. And so if they say, we want a voice to sound like this, you kind of do that. And so, it's just a different way of using the instrument, really, for me. That's how I look at it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Is it is one more fun? Is one more satisfying? Is there like... I mean, I guess the answer is probably...
Ask me after the Juno Awards.
The answer is the thing that gets a Juno. Yeah, I totally get it.
I'm so lucky. I mean, really, everything... I love everything that I do.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on the day. Just like anything. I mean, you know yourself, right? Some days things are annoying and you think, God, why am I doing this?
Yeah.
And then other days you kind of look around and go, this is the best thing ever that
right
I do.
Right now this is my favorite thing. You know, we're hanging out. Again, I like this couch. I'm getting paid. You know, I mean,
absolutely.
It's all good.
But yeah, no, I love the singing. Is beautiful, and then the voice work is so much fun. It's creative. It's all about just being creative and being able to work in an art that you know you get paid and you make money and you can pay your bills doing something. It's so much fun.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you so much.
And congratulations on the dogs.
Thank you.
Is it just like facebook.com/Heather Brambick? Like if people just search your name?
Heather Brambick. Yeah, you can find me there. Heather Brambick Music.
Okay, there we go. And that's and then we'll see dogs and outfits.
You will see dogs and outfits.
You also had a couple of bags. Like, did you gone shopping today? Is this?
We get a pillow.
You get a pillow?
We get a pillow.
Sounds like there's a Casper setup over there, right?
It's fantastic. It's like, here, spend tens of thousands of dollars to make a record. Here's your pillow.
Here's a pillow.
Congratulations.
Congratulations on the pillow. That's amazing.
I will be carrying it all the way home.
That's great,
I might walk back to Etobicoke carrying my pillow.
It's perfect. Okay, well, go over there, get your photo taken.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank
Enjoy the day.
Thank you so much. Thank
Cheers.
You.
Cheers. Throw down the mic.
Done.
Awesome.
Thank you for that.
So I really hope people have been tweeting the Juno Awards to try to figure out whether it should be Juno Nauts or Juno Heads or whatever. Up next, we have no, we don't. I keep throwing Kellen totally under the bus. How's it going? Sam.
Aaron Pichette. Nice,
nice to meet you. Come on and take. Yeah, take the award. Yeah, there you go. That's it. That's yours. None of these are mine. That's for sure.
Pretty sure I had this when I was.
Yeah. 10. See, I was joking that this looks a lot like my parents' basement, but like there were no sports awards. No. Like there was nothing. Like at one point, maybe I had like, I played softball. I wasn't very good at it. Did you play a lot of sports as a kid?
I still play hockey my entire life. Since
so
I
you got a lot of these?
I had a bunch of them. I don't know where they went.
Yeah. Were you ever any good?
I played a bit. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, congratulations.
I still play. I'll be in the JUNO Cup now.
Yeah, oh, yeah, there we go. Yeah. Well, congratulations on the nomination.
Thank you very much.
I know we had a few other nominees in the category sort of wishing you well. Cole Creek Country Guys. Like,
oh, yeah.
Hope Aaron does pretty awesome. Well. Yeah, exactly.
Good guys.
So you got a lot of respect in this category, clearly.
I'd like to think so. I mean, there's points in my career when I've gone, you know, am I done?
Yeah.
You know, is it over? It's been 8 years since I was nominated last. And there's been many, many times where I've thought, I'll never be nominated again. And single tear. But it's come around. And I guess there is I don't want to say respect. I would just say that it's nice to be able to feel a little validated with this record. Scott Cook is a producer on it and just nailed it. Nailed it out of the park. And he's one of the main reasons why this is nominated in my mind.
Yeah.
It's really nice to be back on board and win this beautiful MVP award.
2004 MVP award. And am I correct? Was the last album you put out before this was a greatest hits record? This is the first sort of album of original material? Because sometimes the greatest hits record is like, I get it, I need a minute, I'm not sure. And so to come back with an album of original material after a greatest hits record and get the nomination has got to be kind of satisfying, right?
That's exactly what that was. Mm. Stretch your arms. It's the way to go. Okay, let me rethink this. How am I going to work this? With the push of a lot of people, especially my family, my girlfriend Jessie, my sons, a lot of people saying, you know what, keep going, don't stop. And I didn't. And here we are today, back in 2017, 8 years later, back on this stage. And who knows, if I don't win, I don't win. I don't worry about that kind of stuff. I let that just play itself out. But I'm on the nomination list, and that's a win to me. Yeah. So.
Does the motivation for writing change at all? Like, or where you're writing from change?
I think the quality of writers you get to write with after something like this happens, it's like, hey, we want to write with that guy. Maybe he'll get another nomination for an award. But I would say my process doesn't stop being the way it is. It's I kind of watch the industry and how it's moving and where it's going, and I try and think about 6 months down the road. Am I writing the song that's going to be played 6 or 8 months down the road? So that's always been the process, and that's not going to change.
Yeah, awesome. Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
On this trophy, maybe the other trophy in Ottawa on April 2nd? April 2nd, yeah. Cheers, man. Congratulations.
Thank you. Cheers.
Head over there, get your photo taken. Right. Just throw the mic down. We're great.
I'll take this, but I'll put it.
You can take, I think at some point that has to get returned. I don't know. So up next, we have Amoy nominated for Reggae Recording of the Year. How's it going? Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Take a seat, grab a microphone.
All right. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, well, you know, thanks for being here in this like amazing set Okay. That's a nice bag.
Thank you.
How's the day been for you? Thank you for putting that back, by the way.
Oh. Exciting.
Yeah.
Exciting. It's my third nomination, so I'm hoping that three is the charm.
Three is the charm. Right? It's interesting because this category does have a lot of like people that have been nominated 6 times, seven times. It's real like rarefied air. It kind of feels
like a 4-time winner right behind me, Esco Levi.
Exactly. That's competition.
Right.
Do you think you got him this year? Think you can do it?
Yeah, I think the universe has a plan.
Yeah,
has a plan. Yes.
How's the last year been for you? I mean, obviously this album was well received, but you know. Has it been different at all this last year?
Exciting. It's a mixtape that I had out that Sorry was on, and it was well received.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people were loving and showing a lot of love to Sorry, which got nominated today. And it makes me feel encouraged and fulfilled to know that that I'm on the right track. I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
Am I correct? Have you played Exit in Serbia?
Festival.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what?
Three
so
times.
One of my closest friends in high school was Serbian, and he actually moved back and like lived there for a long time. And it just seemed like it's a very different musical culture. So what is that festival like? I mean, I've never been.
Oh my gosh, it's 150,000 people.
Yeah.
Imagine that, and everybody camps out. It was an experience I'll never forget. Every time I went there, it was special. I was on the positive vibration stage, the reggae stage, and 1 year it was the headliner was Snoop Dogg. Mm-hmm. There was people like Jamiroquai. So it's a variety of different genres of music, people coming together to show love to good music.
Does it differ from other festival experiences that you've had?
Yes, absolutely. This one, the people, they love their music, and they're not afraid to show it, you know? Especially to reggae music, you know? And when I tell them, they knew even the lyrics to the songs.
Yeah.
And they're Serbians.
Yeah.
So it was quite fun, I
did not
say.
Know, yes. I mean, in my mind, Serbians just listen to, like, the sounds of machines grinding. But that's because, that might be a really problematic thing that I just said, actually.
Yeah, reggae music.
I should not. Yeah, that's awesome. Well, congratulations.
Thank you so much
and,
for having me.
You know, good luck, you know, unseating all these guys. Yeah,
I know, right?
Yeah.
I know. Thank you so much.
Cheers. Congratulations.
Cheers.
Yeah, go over there and you can get your photo taken. Juno people taking the pics.
Sweet.
And now we have the man that you have to beat up.
Esco Levi.
Esco Levi, nominated for Reggae Recording of the Year. Just snapping it. Not interested. No? Oh, hey, it's a Strumbella. That's not... You guys are not nominated for Reggae Recording of the Year. How's it going, guys? Good to see you.
How are you?
How's it going? Good to see you. Take a seat, grab a mic. What do you guys think of this set?
Oh, we're just saying it's awesome.
Isn't it cool?
Yeah, it looks very cool.
I'm going to sleep here tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't have a home. It's very sad.
This definitely works, right?
This is 100% like...
This is what's streaming the video right now.
This is actually our encoder.
Yeah.
if we fiddle with this, the entire stream goes down. So please
We won't touch it.
Please be good.
Yeah.
Congratulations on the nomination, guys.
Thanks, man.
Would you say that 2016 was like a crazy year or like... the craziest year? Because like I did an interview with you a week ago, maybe also for a JUNO TV thing, and I don't even think we talked about this, but like that day I took an Uber like to and from a meeting, and in both directions I heard you on the radio. Do you know what I mean? Like I was like, that doesn't happen. Like it's been a year, right? Like it's been a year.
We just have staff that just beam songs into your car wherever you go.
That's quite the luxury, actually.
We're always looking for
actually.
Influencers.
Yeah. Just so that I'll have a chance to talk about it here on the set. Yeah,
sure.
It's a good anecdote. Yeah. How do you measure that in terms of just a wild year for you?
It's something that is kind of like, I think, hard to measure. And it literally was like almost a year ago now when Spirits really started taking off and it all really got started. I think... it's kind of nice sometimes to remind yourself to like sort of sit back and be like, hey, reflect on this moment and sort of like have a good time, because you end up getting sort of busy and like, you know, all these things meld together. So this is kind of a nice moment to kind of sit back and be like, wow, it was a crazy year. And like, what an exciting, awesome way to cap it off with 3 nominations. It's so cool.
A lot of people, when we talk about their nomination, it's like, I texted my mom, I texted my dad. Yeah. But they're like, they finally get it. Like, it's like the JUNO nomination was the thing that, like, really made sense for them. But, like, you guys have had a series. The JUNO nomination is obviously great, but there's been all these other things that have probably legitimized what you do to your parents or parental figures in your life. What was the most legitimizing thing of the last year, you know, where they were like, oh, you're not just out there playing music wild in the street?
Oh, man, that's a really good question. There is, I think, still, unfortunately, something about... doing well in the U.S. for Canadians, you know, that is always legitimizing. So I think maybe it was playing on Colbert or playing on Jimmy Kimmel Live. Like that, I think, has this effect of people being like, oh, Dave, like, actually, like, has, like, a career.
Open mic with Mike Bullard never held the same cachet.
Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, like, I don't, like, it's... Yeah. Because I know a lot of people that only have careers and have amazing careers in Canada, but there is still this thing... this perception that you've made it when you've made it outside the country.
Yeah.
So that in some ways I think was legitimizing in a way that like other Canadian things haven't been, unfortunately.
And you guys are going to be performing at the Junos this year, April 2nd in Ottawa on CTV. Nailed it. Great plug.
Yeah.
How do you guys approach an award show performance? Is it the same? Do you guys try to do something special?
This will be our first award show performance.
Okay, yeah.
So we got to get to the drawing board, I think. Like,
yeah.
We got to start thinking about this.
Yeah, other people do this a lot, and this will be our first one. So I think it's like, there's like an 80% chance we're going to fail, I think.
I've never seen anyone fully crash and burn. at the Junos.
Well,
maybe
don't
I'm
worry.
Forgetting something. Yeah, yeah. There's time, guys.
Yeah, someone can still do it.
Just
yeah.
put it in the calendar.
I'm just waiting for you guys to like have a full like Mariah on New Year's type moment where it's just like it becomes very obvious that you're lip syncing.
I mean, I don't think anyone's gonna die. I just think you might. I just think you know there's a lot of people in our band. If a few of us have a little bit of a deer in the headlights look, I don't know if I'd be totally surprised.
Okay, great.
But I mean, I think we'll still be able to own it, though. I think. I think we'll. We'll be able to own screwing up. Like, we'll make it a part of us.
So this is a really good reason for people to make sure that they watch the Junos just see how badly the Strombellas play. It's going to be exciting.
Like, I feel like I just had a breakthrough.
I think we jinxed ourselves. Like,
yeah,
I'm actually
terrible.
Worried at this point.
You guys messed up, but congratulations anyway. Keep this guy rolling. Yeah. Congratulations on the nominations.
Thank you.
Thanks, man.
And see you guys in Ottawa.
Awesome.
Yeah, head over there. They're taking photos of everybody, and just throw your mic down on the couch.
Cool.
Like you never needed them. Yeah, exactly. It's like there haven't been enough opportunities for dramatic mic drops. That was pretty good. Up next, we have Esco Levi nominated for Reggae Recording of the Year. Congratulations. How's it going, dude?
Good, you?
Good day?
Come on, give thanks. Thank you.
Yeah. So grab a mic. Yeah, there you go. So you kind of are like the shadow that looms very large over this category, right? Like, I've had a couple of conversations, everyone's like, I'm gonna try to like come at the king a little bit. It's tough. What do you think of the other artists that are nominated in this category this year?
I mean, they're great artists, and I mean, people like Blessed, you have won before.
Yeah.
Dubmatics, you have won before also. Mm-hmm. We have Amai, she nominated before.
Yeah.
I've never won. We have Jay Carty, which is a new artist. So it's really showing progress, you know, for reggae music and showing the growth. You understand? It's also an honor for me, because we celebrate Bob Marley's birthday yesterday.
Yes, that's right. A happy belated. Yeah.
Happy belated birthday.
Yeah.
The king
yeah.
of reggae music. So I'm honored, you know what I mean, to represent my culture. You know, Canada is a vast country that represents people from across the world, you know. Mm-hmm. And we not only bring our physical body here, Canada, we brought our music, we brought our culture, we brought our food. And we're a multiracial country that appreciate everyone's, food and music. So it's really a joy for me. I can't get over nominated for the JUNO. Not to mention winning. It's really a joy for me.
I do think the food is the most important part. I mean, I love the music, but I'm so grateful like that I can go to the Real Jerk in Toronto.
Jerk Chicken.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I got. Yeah, I'm a fan. I'm a fan.
Okay.
Pat's home style is like right nearby me in terms of like getting jerk and like
nice.
That is so that's my jerk spot.
Okay.
Yeah, yes. The oxtail gravy, it's lovely. you mentioned Jay is like a new nominee in this category.
Yeah.
Are there other up and coming artists that you've had an opportunity to like let open for you that you've sort of co-signed? Like, who else are you excited about?
Well, there's an
this
artist
world?
Called Isos. I think he's Canada's biggest dancehall artist.
Yeah,
I mean he's doing so well. You know, I mean. This youth is great, so just look out for him.
Cool.
You know, I think he'll be on the staging soon. You mentioned
yesterday was Bob Marley's birthday. Did you do anything for it besides like putting on some records? Anything special?
We celebrate at a small club there in Brampton. You know, what I mean, lone Bob Marley all night. We were singing One Love.
Yeah.
It was a joy. You know what I mean? For people like Bob Marley who represent us so well, not only us as black people, but people, you know, all One Love. Let's get to it. The song of the century. It's really a joy for me, you know, because they have set the precedent from them time. So Esco Levi and all these great artists, we are the one who is waving that banner scenery for positive, uplifting music across the world.
It is for everyone. It's like I got a friend who's, I think he's Italian, and his son is named Nesta.
Yeah.
Like, and I'm like, is your son named after Bob Marley? And like, I don't know. He's never really answered it me clearly, but I think he is. So like,
yeah. I mean, he's just a great artist. Man.
Yeah,
I mean,
truly.
I mean, I have some white friends, you know, and they say, Esco, my favorite artist is Bob Marley. I'm and they can sing some Bob Marley that I don't even know.
Yeah,
I'm
they
like,
go
what?
They go deep. They go deep.
They go deep. Like I'm saying, but it's really a joy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. His life was cut off short. I believe at 36, but the work. And he left behind. And his sons, you know what I mean? Ziggy Marley, Stephen Marley, they are holding the banner there. And it is music, reggae music, positivity.
Yeah. Well, congratulations on another
nomination. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
See you in Ottawa in April.
Yes, see you in Ottawa. Thank you very much.
Cheers, man.
That's it, bro. Thank you.
Go over there. They're taking photos of all the nominees as well. Up next, we have Harrison nominated for Electronic Album of the Year. Or, wait, no, Harrison, you gotta chill. We have White Horse nominated for Blues Album of the Year. Not Electronic Album of the Year. Come hang. That was like a real stutter step. Congratulations.
Hi, thank you.
Congratulations.
Nice.
Sit down, grab a mic.
Hey.
How you guys doing?
We're good.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
What do you guys think of the set? I keep asking everyone, like, it's my house and I'm trying to brag.
Oh, this.
I know.
It's pretty, like,
very nice.
It's, wood, yeah. It's
warm
very
and cozy.
Woody. Yeah.
And
it's, I mean, yeah, it's not entirely basement. It's more like a cabin in the woods.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah, there's like, there's a body under the floorboards. It's,
you have to leave now because that's actually what happened.
I just blew your cover.
I know, exactly. Like, this is, this whole thing is actually like an incredibly elaborate ploy for me to hide bodies. This is an exciting nomination for you guys because previously you've won for Adult Alternative Album of the Year. This is a blues album, so it's kind of like a totally different approach.
Yeah.
Tell me about the impetus for recording an album like this.
This was just a fun little art project for us. We had no expectations outside of the studio. It was just, you know, let's take some old classics that we know and love and let's do our white horse thing to it. We wanted to take some of our live elements using looping and lots of layering. And so it was really an experiment and we didn't know how it was going to turn out. And it was really a lot of fun to make. And we captured the whole thing on video, so it was all kind of documented, and we were really happy with the result and really proud of it. And you know, we still thought of it as just this kind of like little sleeper album that we just kind of put out into the world, and so we did not expect to get nominated, so this is a pleasant surprise.
It's really exciting. Yeah. It's nice to sort of do things. There's a few people that I've talked to who are like, this is the album I just did for fun.
Yeah,
you know, it's like, this is sort of, but you know, when you kind of just follow your heart, I don't mean to be like really corny about it, but it's, there's something to be said for just making the thing you kind of just want to make.
And I mean, it's not, we're sort of giving the impression that there's something diminutive about doing it just for fun.
Yeah.
No, just for fun is the loftiest. I mean, the reason most of us make rock and roll music is because we didn't make the football team or we weren't ballet dancers or whatever it happens to be. Mm-hmm. Not to just put like ridiculous gender binary roles on our lives, but you know what I'm saying, right? Mm-hmm. You choose to play rock and roll because you fail at the other things that the cool kids were up to.
I'm terrible at football.
I've joked about the fact that this looks a lot like my basement, except there were no sports trophies in my basement. So yeah, no, I know exactly what you're saying.
I had like the participation like ribbon.
The whole ribbon, yeah. Not even a trophy, but a ribbon.
Yeah.
I mean, doing things just for fun is essentially the whole point of rock and roll. And you know, this is a blues record, but you know, I use the term rock and roll loosely, but maybe the best thing about the record and maybe the reason why it's such a success artistically, and I think it is, like, I listen to the record and I like it. I don't listen to our records because it sounds like work. This record doesn't sound like work to me. It sounds like 5 days of us in the studio playing. And maybe that's why it's successful. Maybe that's why it was an artistic triumph for us, which I feel like it was.
That's awesome. Well, congratulations,
guys.
Thank you
very
much. Very cool nomination.
Thanks a lot.
Cheers.
Thanks.
Have a great day. Go over there. They're taking photos of everybody. Just throw them down, cast them aside. And now, it was a psych out earlier, Harrison nominated for Electronic Album of the Year. Come hang. Yeah, yeah. Like this, threw everyone off there for
a
second. Yeah. Come on, take a seat. I'm good, man. Grab a mic. Yeah, it's like real, it's deep. Grab one of those microphones. I haven't leaned back in like an hour.
Oh, really?
But I feel
back.
Like
it
just, I feel like it doesn't scan well on camera. Like it looks like a little too casual. Or just like, what's up, man? How's it going?
Nice.
Yeah, congratulations on the nomination, man.
Thanks, dude, I appreciate it.
Did you say all you need is a joint?
Yeah. some giggle bush?
Yeah, see, I was straight edge in high school, so like,
really?
I've never smoked weed on a couch that looks like this.
Oh, really?
I'm only, only like IKEA brand couches.
You gotta go for that 70s show shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hold on, I'm getting this use the mic reminder from Kelly. Yeah.
I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about that stuff in the Junos.
No, I checked, we're allowed to say fucking weed and... whatever you need to say.
Nice.
So how are you feeling today? How's this?
I'm great, dude. I'm super stoked. I just texted my dad. He's shook. He's stoked because I didn't know what this was.
Yeah.
In the disclaimer, it's like, just because you're invited doesn't mean you're nominated.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay.
I'm just going to a party like on the outskirts of Toronto.
Yeah.
Thank you to the Rebel for hosting us.
I was like, Dad.
So this is a surprise, like totally a surprise.
Yeah. Well, like somewhat.
Yeah.
And I didn't, but I did, because I don't trust anything until it's right there on the board.
That's cool, man. I feel like you're also like representative of, it's exciting, this is reading like all the bios for people who are nominated, then I feel like yours is the only one that has SoundCloud like in the bio.
No.
I was like, but it's a sign of the way that things are sort of transitioning, right? And I think it's really exciting to sort of on some level you're now like on the vanguard of what I'm sure like in 2 years like everyone's going to be like, this artist started on SoundCloud, this is artist from Bandcamp.
Well, that's, it's a good thing though, right? It's like, you know, I was making music in my bedroom.
Yeah.
And, like, still do make music in my bedroom, you know? You can do that, and there's possibilities to get here.
Do you think people are sort of seeing more of that? Like, you have the success of, like, people like Kay Trinata and, like, you know, who's, like, very outspoken about the fact that he's making records, like, in his mom's house.
Yeah, exactly.
And, like, he's like, what's wrong with that?
There's nothing wrong with it. He's killing it.
Yeah, but it's something that you... The capacity to do that's been there for a long time. Grimes did it. Do you think people are really recognizing, like, no, I seriously can do this, like, on a laptop in my parents' house?
People are like, you know, there's, like, a thing behind, like, you got to be in, like, the studio. It's like, no, man, you can do, you can get a shitty mic and just record right into your fucking computer. You can do it. It's easy. And you don't have to make it harder for yourself.
If you were recommending, like, one program for someone who, like, wants to do kind of what you do, what would you recommend?
Ableton, for sure. Ableton, you know, like... You know, save up for a good Mac or build a good PC. I'm just saying Mac for mobile reasons to play shows. Get Ableton. I'm not going to, you know.
Sponsored by, yeah.
I'm not going to plug Ableton. I'm not going to plug piracy either. But
Get it.
Get Ableton. Find a way to get it.
Secure Ableton in some capacity. Exactly. Yeah. I don't promote any of this. This is terrible. Easy. Yeah. Congratulations on the nomination, man. Congrats on the day. I'm glad your dad's stoked.
Yeah, I'm glad he's stoked, too.
Yeah. And they're taking photos of all the nominees over there, so nice. Go get your beautiful picture
Sounds
taken.
Good, man. I hope you're almost done.
Yeah, I mean, I can't. It's pretty quiet in here, so I think we're getting down to it. So cheers, man. Up next, we have Holy Fuck, nominated for Electronic Album of the Year. Correct? Correct. Yeah. How's it going, man?
Good, how are
you? Doing great. Take a seat, grab a mic. How's it going?
Very well. It's going good.
So you're here towards the end. So, like, what have you been doing for the last hour?
Just like more hanging out with my friends. Actually, it's great. People I don't really get to see very often, which is a fantastic perk of events.
It's a
like
real
this,
perk of the Junos for sure. Like, I always notice that, like, when it's away, it's always so interesting to me. Like last year in Calgary, where you're like, oh, you have like an entire. I mean, not an entire, but like a lot of aspects of a music community just sort of plunked down.
Yep.
Oftentimes in the cities that are smaller than like the place, you know, if it's a bunch of people from Toronto and everyone's in Calgary, it's like, it's kind of fun. Just shove everyone in a room and fill them up with alcohol and like see what happens.
Exactly, hilarity ensues.
Exactly. Have you sent any text messages? Have you like let anyone know what's up?
I checked my coat. Yeah. And my phone is in the pocket. So I've been phoneless this whole time.
Wow.
Just fine.
You're living in a bold future.
Or an obsolete past somehow.
Yeah, I guess. Are you really stressed? Like, I feel like when I like do this and I'm like, oh no, it's not there.
I was for 30 seconds and then I shed it and I'm okay.
Wow. Actually, this is exciting. Maybe I'm going to like my phone is in my pocket right now. Mm-hmm. I can't use it. Like, what am I going to do with my phone right now? Like, I'm sitting here talking to
exactly.
people.
Exactly. I am getting the phantom vibrations though. Oh yeah. Leg, just like,
it's spooky, man.
Yeah.
So there was a long wait between albums for you guys. I mean, this was like 6 years.
Yeah. Between releases.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, whenever there's a wait like that, I'm always curious sort of what the motivation is always to sort of go back and do another full length, to do...
Well, we made a point to take a bit of a break, maybe not this long of a break. Our record before came out in 2010. Prior to that, we were really, really busy. We started in 2004, 2005, kind of really getting momentum and kind of went really hard touring and getting out there as much as we could.
Mm-hmm.
And then we put out our last record, Latin, in 2010, toured that a whole bunch, which actually took up a bit of the break that people say we were actually out promoting that record for a couple
of
years.
Yeah, so it was not a break.
And we made a decision to kind of like slow things down a little bit. Mm. We wanted to take our time with this record and really make it something we wanted. We had the ideas in our head and we wanted to kind of take our times with it and allow ourselves time to flesh things out. And last thing I'll mention, three of the four of us had children too. So that also kind of like...
Congratulations.
The
magic of child rearing.
Yeah. So that definitely was a factor in the equation as well.
Slow things up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Were you one of the...
Yes.
So congrats.
Yes, thanks.
Do you think your kid is going to care about the Junos?
I don't know. She knows what it is.
Yeah, she's probably not
there. She's 5 and a half. I guess this maybe...
When do you start teaching children about the Junos? Like,
that is a good question. I'll let you know. I don't even know if she knows the name of my band just yet.
Yeah, when do you broach that?
I don't know that either. We have to kind of like, we're, you know, teaching her good boundaries and proper etiquette and rules and stuff.
And then you're just going to ruin it all by being daddy plays in a fuck band. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Well, congratulations on the nomination and being a dad.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, cheers. Head over there. They're taking photos of everybody. Throw the mic down. Cheers, man. All right, so we have been doing this for a minute, and I'm impressed that there are people still here, milling, which is great, and people watching. Right now we have The Fretless, nominated for Instrumental Album of the Year. How's it going, man?
Good, how are you doing?
Sam, good to meet you.
Carnell, nice to meet you.
Take a seat, grab a mic. How you doing?
Good, really, really great.
I'm curious, with the artists that are still here, just talking to Holy Fuck, what have you been doing for the last hour and a half?
Just getting free pillows.
Yeah,
the later you stay, the more pillows you get.
Do you think I get a pillow?
I don't know.
I wonder, is Jill around? Yeah. Does anyone know if I get a pillow? Ashley, do you think I get a pillow? No one's listening to me.
No, no one cares. No one wants you to get a pillow.
I've been talking for 90 minutes. I am white noise. No one hears anything when I open my mouth
anymore.
There's
no empty champagne glasses around, so that's,
no, I know.
That's embarrassing.
I know, right? I've just been here straight edge the entire time. You guys have been nominated for a lot of other awards. Looking at the bio, it's this. You've got some hardware.
Yeah.
But this is the first Juno.
First Juno nomination.
So what does that mean to you?
Man, it's awesome. This is what you strive for in the Canadian music scene, obviously. And I was saying earlier to some other people that, in my opinion, the Junos does a really good job of not just grasping on commercial successes, but really grasping on people that are going and touring hard and writing great songs and playing great music. So it's just an honor. I mean, it's a really tough category that we're in. It's not just one genre. Mm-hmm. It's various genres. So we're just excited to be part of the Juno nomination team.
Are you guys going to be at the show in April? Are you going to try to come out to Ottawa?
I'm just literally going to go home and try and reschedule a tour.
And reroute yes. I got to do it.
Get some fake tour or fake tears and say not fake, but real tears of saying I need to go, I want to go.
Oh, yeah. I thought you meant you were going to fake a family emergency or
something.
Well,
that might
happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, that's worthwhile. If you make it to Ottawa, April 2nd, the show on CTV.
Yes.
Thank you also to the Ontario Media Development Corporation. Just want to make sure I'm getting all my check.
Yeah.
Is there someone you're particularly excited to try to bump into? Be like, oh, hey, Shawn Mendes, what's up?
I mean, anybody and everybody. We're an instrumental band for the most part. And we've always kind of pursued working with other artists and whether it's singer songwriters or rappers, anything. And one of the tracks on our latest album, we want to get a rapper on it. So, anybody that would entertain the idea of working with us on this track and just experimenting, what could happen?
Yeah. So it's kind of an exciting networking opportunity for you, right?
Totally.
Yeah. But not the crappy version of that.
No, I mean, let's here's a glass of wine, chat with these people and see what happens.
The mimosas have been flowing, so I feel it's fairly easy. People are in a celebratory mood.
There's still a few mimosas, but the pillows are...
Oh, there's mimosas still?
Yeah.
This is great news.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get a mimosa, I'm going to get a pillow. Congratulations on the nomination.
Thanks so much, man.
And hopefully see you in Ottawa when you cry and everything works out. And I think they're taking photos of all the nominees over there, so just go get your picture taken.
Right, man.
Cheers,
thank
man. You. Congrats. All right, we're done. It is 12:57. I feel like we started at 11:30, 11:40. So that was an hour and a half. Jill, please, yes. This is Jill. Jill produces the show and brings me my mimosas. Thank you very much to the whole Juno TV crew. Thank you to everyone at Rebel, everyone at CARAS. The Juno Gala is Saturday, April 2nd, and that'll be live streaming on all of the various Juno platforms, the names of which have escaped me because I've been talking for so long. And the show itself is the Sunday, April 2nd, on CTV. You heard them announce some of the performers. It's going to be an incredible show. I will be doing this backstage both nights. So if you were like, that was cool, I wish I could hear him talk for 4 hours, you will have that opportunity. Thanks so much to EventStream and everyone who has made this show possible. I'm going to drink this. Thank you to Kellen for making the prompter mostly work. Sorry when it occasionally didn't. I'll see you guys in Ottawa. Goodbye.